coming home again tonight. And save your tears this time. I'm coming home again to make you right.
Hey, my dude.
Hi. Very good evening to all you people inside Twitch chat. Thank you all for coming so early. Everyone's already in the server. We've got the binds all sorted out and good to go. Tonight is going to be a Div 1 matchup. We've got ifun on the casting panel. Hello, ifun.
Hello, friend.
Nice. We've got the Prinny Pirate Plunderers facing off against Eat Sleep Game. That is the PPP going up against ESG, of course. ESG is the Korean team, so tonight we are going to be playing on a Hong Kong server. So ping will be fairly equal between everyone. And yeah, got a lot of familiar names in there, so please give us some insight on the teams, ifun.
I'm seeing a lot of course, I'm already familiar with the blue team, Prinny Pirate Plunderers. I played with them for a week one match, I think, or week two. I'm not very familiar with what week, but both teams are very equal. Mm-hmm. I'm not exactly familiar with the score lines, but I think they have the same standing, but only differing in 1 point or 2 points. And they both tied to Sapnu Puas, another playoff team. Ooh. With the Koreans getting 3-3 and PPP getting 5-5, I think.
Oof. Really close games coming up from both teams. Hopefully we get to see some close matches coming up tonight. So far, every single cast has been a, you know, it's pretty straightforward matches. I want to see some close matches, some tight games. Hopefully we get to see that tonight. Based on your personal opinion, are there any standout players playing tonight?
I think Pandemic and Strelka. LK.
Mm. So both the scouts for both sides. We've got Pandemic for the side of the Prinnies. And of course, ESG, we've got LK. LK, definitely a name that everyone is very familiar with. We've seen him play for the previous seasons as well. Full Korean team, they do a massive job of just massive scout work coming up from both sides. The other players, of course, you know, nothing, you know, it's not like they're just there to fill in slots. They're all very capable players. We've got Daylight, another familiar name we've seen from previous seasons. Strelka as well. I don't think I've seen Harsh, personally. I don't think I've seen Pokey either. So those are a couple of new names. For
yeah,
myself.
Definitely. Mm-hmm. I mean, I've been familiar with the Koreans with Kalpushi.
Oh yeah,
the Kalpushi meme of losing head. I think they replaced them with Pokey and Huyen, the
Ah
Master
yes,
Rover.
Yep. So Baxter is taking over Huyen now. So instead of Huyen, it's Baxter. I can't remember who the demo man was, but it is gonna be Harsh this time around. Just gonna give them the green light, so they should be able to start anytime soon. Do you have any predictions?
I think this is gonna be a B2 for either team. Both teams are very equal with very aggressive scouts, which is very helpful in product, and it seems like we're gonna start.
Yep, we are gonna be on an AF server, so that means we're gonna be going live on a couple of restarts. We're gonna see some fairly standard rollouts. Gonna follow the Devilman Lil for his rollout for the start of the PPPs. For those of you who are just joining us, once again, very good evening. Welcome to the AsiaFortress Cup Season 13 Div 1 Upper Bracket Semifinals. It's the Prinnies facing off against Eastly Game. And we are gonna be going live on the first map of the night. It's gonna be Koth Product, followed by CP Process. The tiebreaker map, of course, is gonna be CP Snakewater. So here we are, gonna have Lil's already gonna start spamming those sticks onto the point. The scouts for the side of the Koreans are gonna be making their way forward. You see LK once again just trying to zone out those two soldiers inside connector. And we are gonna see some scout action on this point.
Oh, the soldiers are going behind cliff.
Oh. Yeah, we got the
Korean. Oh my god, he's 2v1ing! He's 2v1ing Baxter's 2v1ing in cliff. He's actually going aggressive on the cliff side, and we're killer takes him out.
Oh, LK just walks forward, whips out that pistol, and picks up EV. That's the medic down for the side of the Prinnies. They got no heals, so this is gonna put them at a disad. The time, of course, gonna start counting down for the side of the Koreans, and wow, losing your med. Nothing much going on right now, just capping the point. The Koreans just holding their ground, not holding too far forward. Of course, the Prinnies can't afford to go extremely aggro. Aggressive bomb straight down into the medic, gonna get the force, and they're just gonna start jumping out. Smiley does get out with his life. EV, of course, still carefully building back at spawn. They do get the force, so that is gonna be the silver lining for them losing their three players. They don't have the point, so that means they're gonna get much faster spawn timers. And they're all gonna be up. They're all gonna have that Uber charge ready to go. Start pushing onto that point. Harsh gonna get those stickies up on the left side to see if he can sticky out some people. But the Solly's already gonna be jumping up top, getting denied kill. Gonna eat a lot of damage. Smiley gonna be right there. He's gonna get ragdolled across that rooftop. They're just going to be moving forward. The medic, of course, already far, far in safety, and they're going to pop that Uber charge and walk straight forward. Pistols coming up from Pandemic once again. The scout going to be that connector, but he is possibly going to get shot down once Pandemic gets those meat shots.
Yeah, there's a lot of players here.
Ooh, LK still alive. Of... Ooh,
what?
There you go.
Oh, what a turnaround. They get Strolka and LK. Both scouts are currently down right in mid, especially with two up only for Koreans. I think this is going to be a blue side take.
Yeah, they're going to be able to re-grab this midpoint. We got Smiley watching that China spot. Going to jump forward, spots the Solly down below, tosses out some rockets, but not enough to kill him. He does get spotted in the end, and he's just going to start backing out without getting any kills. And midpoint in the hands of Blue. The Prinnies aren't going to hold on to this midpoint, but they're holding on their side of the field. You can see the side of the ESG players just moving forward, inching them off that point. They've got their full Uber charge, and then don't intend to use it anytime soon, but they have to pop it. They get forced by that Solly jumping in. Smiley's going to be able to back out on their side, so that's one Solly they have to worry that's currently behind them. Killed is trying to go against everyone right there on their cliffside, and Smiley is making his way forward, jumping up on that spot behind everyone. They don't know he's behind, so he may be able to get some picks down to the medic. The medic apparently was taken down, and he's just coming in a little bit too late, and the rest of his team already cleaned up the rest of them.
Yeah, I think that was a little bit too aggressive by the Koreans. They could have played the point, stalled for time. They already had a 1 minute advantage, actually a 1.5 minute advantage there. Mm-hmm. So if they tried to not chase over that choke point at the cliffside, I think that would have been way better with a leapfrog for them to push another bid.
Yep, so they're not going to have that Uber charge to contest this mid anytime soon, but they will start sending people in to see if they can get that force. The medic's going to be holding on to that cliffside, hanging really, really far back. Don't want to lose the Uber charge. And this is just giving the Koreans so much space to inch forward. Daylight just watching that connector spamming out a couple of the rockets. He's not going to be able to get much done apart from some damage. I take that back. He does take down Smiley and kill Killer. And that is the Uber popped for the side of the Prinnies. They do pick up Pokey though? Okay. And yeah, the Koreans are desperately throwing people down up front. We're going to have Strelka and LK just massively mowing down all their players. And they will be able to re-grab this midpoint with a minute on their clock. LK trying to go for the kill, he gets Killer.
Yeah.
Oof, another frag down for LK. They do grab this midpoint and their timer is ticking down, yeah.
I mean, that was really aggressive on the left side, and they were able to take down the two players here, and it seems like blue team is trying to push. No, they're defending against that soldier here that's currently aggressively killing them here. The scouts, double scout duo, going to go in that right side area. 18 HP on the pandemic. He's actually surviving. What? Great movement, MGE movement.
Strelka and LK were so far forward, but they still make it back alive. They're gonna start grinding out that Uber chart. They got slight air, 20% or so. And Smiley, this is gonna spark a jump from him. Spots the medic, but doesn't gain quite enough distance. Does land a couple of damage down onto the medic. He may pick up this red Solly here. The fall damage is not enough. He does finish up with that rocket. The timer is ticking down. They gotta start second the point. The medic's right there. He does get the force, but they are just doing massive cleanup. I don't think Killer can do anything about this. Killer trying his very best, 73 health, he's gonna get scattershot into the ground.
That was actually very perfect for a red team, because like they had Ubrad and then they had 10 seconds they had 10 seconds alive on the point.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, that was an easy mid for them.
Very well played. Coming up from the Koreans, ESG going to be able to grab that first point on the map. First to three, of course, is what we're going to be playing to. And Lowe's going to start reaching mid, and we got a tactical pause. And a tactical unpause. Right, there you go. So they are going to start spamming each other out. We got the Solly jumping forward and another tactical pause while Smiley is currently hanging out midair. And the another unpause goes down. Smiley jumps forward and he jumps back. Not too sure if the pauses stop the momentum of the Koreans. And we have another pause because why?
Is this allowed? Is this allowed?
No idea what's going on.
This is three pauses already. I don't think this is allowed in the rule set.
It's being paused by the Korean team? Did something happen?
Yeah, they lost their scout Strelka here.
Oh, yes.
Especially in product. This is a very scout-heavy map. Mm-hmm. I don't think they want to fight mid here. Especially with this one scout down.
Yeah, and Strelka and LK have been doing a massive job so far. They've been just working off each other extremely well. They helped each other survive many situations, get so many picks. So reaching this mid with Strugger, probably just gonna be coming in late. Not too sure if they want to contest this. You see they're already holding back with just all the players for the side of the Prinnies already flooding onto the point. So we're just gonna have to see how they play through once Strugger comes back in. But based on what we've seen previously, what do you think the Prinnies can actually do to like improve their odds? Because they've been just
they're getting rampaged on the flank side. Especially in that mid hold. Oh, the soldier seems like he's bombing deep. Just distracting. He gets taken out by killed, and then the scout on the connector side doing a 1v1 here. And the demo and the scout pushing onto the cliff side, onto the red team. Oh, it seems like they're not gonna chase, but the demo. Oh, wow. Amazing protection by Pandemic. And it gets arrowed by Eevee. That was actually a very aggressive bomb by the soldiers. Oh, yeah. Didn't achieve much, though.
Yeah, Smiley went deep, but in the end, he just traded together with, I think it was Baxter or Daylight. And now they do hold on to this point. The timer is gonna start ticking down. The Koreans are just waiting to regroup. Both teams have their Uber charge, so they can actually try to see if they can do anything at all. Soli's arguably jumping up top.
Oh, this one right there.
Straight into the face of kill, getting the force. Alright, Eevee panic pops. And he's gonna be able to just pop the Uber charge and hold on to this point. Poki is still holding on to it. He's yet to pop it, and he finally does. But no one is with him. Finally links up with that scout LK, who's just rushing forward, unable to pick up that medic, and this is not gonna be putting them in a favorable situation. They may be able to re-grab this midpoint, but it is gonna spark jumps.
Yeah, it seems like the blue team is trying to refight this. The demo takes a good sticky here, and the scouts actually, the demo man is, Lurl is actually controlling the red scouts very easily here. And it seems like the soldier is gonna bomb the scout. Yeah, he takes down Pandemic there. And then it's just an, oh my god, double scout train coming into the medic. Oh, they didn't get him. Oh no, they get killed! He gets caught at the tail end of that.
Yep, Baxter just launches a rocket up from China, picks up that Soli killed, and they hold on to the
soldier
point.
Prime bombing. Oh, never mind. I thought he was gonna get the medic. He's gonna get lit up here. Hopefully gonna get arrowed in the mid side here. Demo is gonna peeking left, and he's gonna be sick. Oh, what? Soldier? Oh, soldier gets levitated in connector.
Absolutely denied. Smiley's in. Tries to get the pick on the medic, but instead he picks up someone else. That's Harsh going down, so that's no demo, no Soli for the side of the Koreans. Fully recharged for the side of the Prinny, so they gotta hang back for a little while before they decide to do anything too risky for the side of the ESG players. Trying to make their way forward. Strucker just WM1 into the enemy team. LK tried to back him up.
He's spamming the hell out of red team here. That's some good damage. They might even be. Oh, never mind. They get the heals up. What?
Healers down.
What?
Strucker's behind him. Grabs that health pack, spots the other Soli.
Oh my god, he's just crushing that soldier on the. He just levitates him. He's like a magic. It's like a magic show.
Yeah, they popped the Uber charge. I think it's just to push the Prinny players back into spawn. They are going to be able to re-grab this midpoint, and the time is going to start ticking down. But that's going to spark a counter push coming in from the side of the Prinnies. Low already going to start spamming that point with his stickies. Kill, possibly going to jump forward. Does jump up onto the rocks. Misses that landing, but he's going to be fine. Spots the Devil Man, tries to get the air shot. Oh! Demo Man just barely makes it up, and EV apparently dies to a rocket from Daylight.
Yeah, it's time for blue team to sack into the medic here. They need to kill him because they're gonna get good spawns either way. They're not sacking in. Okay, whatever. It seems like they're gonna wait for a buff here, and then they're gonna do a four-man sack again.
Yeah, so
hopefully
the
that's
medic
what's gonna
is
happen.
Following them out. And that's Kill gonna be jumping forward face first into the Demo Man, tries to toss out the rockets, but he's gonna get denied right there. Another aggressive bomb by the Demo Man!
Oh my god!
Oh, Lil just cleaned up what what Kill could not do. Picking up the medic, the demo, as well as the scout. They regrab this mid, and the timers are tied, and their side is counting down now. Holy crap.
That was actually a very good bomb by Kill. Everyone on the red team was looking at him, mm-hmm. and that gave the space for Prinny Pirate Plunderers to push into the middle point, and then their scouts with their aggressive energy, they were able to push them out.
They're gonna start to try to see if they can recounter this push, but the Prinnies are gonna get the Uber charge really soon. That scout is just gonna get absolutely destroyed. LK just gonna ragdoll to the ground. We're gonna have a Soli Daylight, I believe, or is it Baxter who's currently behind them? Baxter spots the medic, tries to get a shot, lands a couple of rockets, but doesn't get the kill. And Uber is gonna get forced. Daylight lands face first into an Uber scout, and he's gonna get scattershotted down. Poki's still gonna be alive though at 44%. They may be able to grind this out and possibly do something.
Oh yeah, it seems like they're pushing in. Oh my god. Ooh,
the two scouts, it's gonna be another double scout rush. They pick up Killer, they're jumping forward, they have the sights down to Pandemic. Strucker trying to land on scatter shots, whips out the pistol to try to finish the job, but Pandemic does somehow make it out. Skill!
Finally gets Pokey! That's not supposed to happen. Now that they have VAD, they're gonna build it out and they're just gonna pop Uber and then get mid. Especially with that 19 second timer for blue side, I think they're gonna be able to cap.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, but it seems like Daylight's hiding here. He might go for a blind bomb. Hopefully someone catches him out. That was a double soldier blind bomb. That should have been called out. That was a rest in peace.
Oh, Lowell is going straight for the medic. They don't spot him yet. Can he get the air pipe down? No, he gets denied. LK comes in with the pistols. They only got the demo and the scout at the front lines together with the medic though, and they got 36% on Uber charge. They gotta see what they can do to hold on to this point for as long as they can. 32 seconds coming down against the Pretty's 19. This is down to the wire.
Still have the, yeah, they still have one more push to make. This is the push to make it or break it. Yeah, it seems like they're gonna go from main here, and the soldiers are gonna be bombing in, taking a lot of damage from the scouts here. The demo is just, oh, actually, Smiley's gonna go bomb in and feed into connector. Another soldier sacking in for the medic. Is he gonna get him? He's gonna go for another jump. This should not be allowed. Yes, killer. Oh, but the demo gets taken out and the scout gets taken out. It's over.
Yeah.
This is gonna be a red team.
Killer tried his best, but they're not gonna be able to grab this point. And the Koreans.
Do you see the
another point?
Yeah, do you see the red soldiers? Like, the red soldiers and the scouts in the flank are actually working it so hard that they're getting caught here and they're giving so much distraction for red team. And that's giving their scouts so much space.
Yeah, so just letting LK and Shocker just run free, that's definitely not something you want. You're gonna see some Solly bombs coming in. Kill gonna be jumping behind him. Connector getting absolutely denied, catching a rocket with his forehead. Lowell gonna try to see if he can spam out their medic, but Solly's gonna be behind, picks up EV! Oh, Baxter, that is huge for his team. They do drop both Solly's though, but they have no heals for the side of the Prinnies. They're gonna lose their scout LK as well, so Strelka's gonna have to do the heavy lifting for his team right now. 75 health, he's gonna get absolutely destroyed by that pipe.
This might actually be a blue mid. Especially with... Oh, never mind. They're gonna be backing out with that health disadvantage.
Yep, so EV finally makes it up to the mid, and apparently the, ESG players are just giving up all that space, letting them cap this point, but the Solly's just flying straight down. Baxter.
Oh, what?
Oh no, he spots the medic! Smiley finishes himself off instead though, and he does pick up Harsh in the end.
Yeah, they do force. Yeah. That's mission well done for blue team here. That's all they needed to do, and then they could leapfrog off that, oh, what? They're losing a lot of players! The medic might die here! Oh my god, that was a good, that was a close call. He almost got Eevee killed.
Eevee just barely makes it out. He's gonna be able to get hold on to that 60% Uber charge. The midpoint's still in the hands of the Koreans. Solly's getting the high ground, spending down those rockets, droplets, standing on the rock to try and deny any jumpers.
Yeah, but those two
right.
down.
And,
that was actually a three down now.
Yeah, they're just gonna have to back out. They don't have any charge to contest this. And yeah, that's, like, that's what they intend to do. Walking out. Baxter may go for a sneaky bomb though. But he's gonna get bullied.
Might, yeah,
the
they
out.
Might
yeah.
work the flank here. I mean, it's up to red team to make a force here, and it seems like the solo, the whole soldiers again.
They get the force. They get the force. They send everybody in. LK is just running forward, links up back with the medic. Strelka has to defend his medic from everyone else who are just pouring in to get that pick. And yeah, Pokey is safe, holding on to the 85% Uber charge. They should be able to just pop in and push into the entire Prinnies, but the Prinnies are going to be hanging back. Smiley going to be standing up on China to see if he can get any forces. They're going to try to grind out that Uber charge, holding really far back, really passively. And ultimately, they don't really want to pop for this, but I don't know, it depends on where they are.
I think they're trying to push here very slowly, very methodical. Oh wait, Smiley going to feed in! Almost gets a soldier there, 90 HP there. So killed. I think he's going to do a bomb here. No, he's just spamming them out. Oh, killer gets taken out. This might be the sack here. Oh, never
Baxter
mind.
Baxter goes down for the demo, man. And they're just cleaning up right now. Strucker does get taken down, but Killed is going to pay for the exchange. Both teams hold on to their Uber charge, though. So, of course, the Koreans, they didn't pop their Uber charge, and Eevee was able to grind his out, holding on to both Uber charge. So this is a potentially dangerous situation for both sides. Surprisingly, we don't see any off classes yet, though, for either side.
They're pushing out very slowly on choke here. I don't think they have any plans of pushing out anymore with two down, especially with that scout, especially with Lurl getting down, the demo in the product. Oh, what? They're still in? This is gonna be very bad for blue team. That Uber gets just gets one scout and that's all that's gonna.
What? He may pick
he's
up
gonna
the
get
demo.
The demo as well? What? Is he gonna. Oh, he gets the force!
Yeah, that is not optimal at all. EV makes it out. Baxter tries to chase, but he's gonna get punished. Whips out the melee, tries to get a trade! Okay, Baxter kills killed. Killed just living up to his name and just dying. And,
Oh, the scout's chasing the man! Oh my god, amazing movement by Eevee! Just spamming A and D scout movement, transitioning into medic. That was some great play right there. I don't know if the scout beefed or just Eevee just juking them out. And it seems like they're pushing from main. They're leading the push here, walking forward. Ooh. Mortar artillery going in hard on the cliff side. Some
Sonic
good
going
damage.
Straight on the cliff. Smiley's behind them. He does get spotted out. Baxter's right there to deny him. They do cap the point though. But there is a slight rat in the hands of the Koreans, so they may be able to do something about this. And they're just walking face first.
Yeah, Eevee needs to not die here. But the blue team is losing too many players here.
Yeah, but you know, the ESG players, they drop both their scouts, and that is definitely not something they need at the moment. They want to try to push in with the supercharge, but if they want to pop the super now, they're going to have to take out Eevee, but Eevee's going to have the supercharge.
Oh, Eevee's taking a lot of damage. This might signal the push for ESG. Oh, yeah, it does signal the push rate. Actually, on the soldiers. Never mind.
Daylight and is Uber's behind them? Okay. So Daylight's all the way behind him, but Killer! Oh, doesn't get that air shot, and Killer is going to be able to land that kill down onto him. And as Daylight down, Strucker's going to link up with the medic.
Cliff. Nobody sees him? Oh, wait, this guy's going for him. Oh, but the medic gets taken out by LK!
Wow. He's still alive, he's still alive. Tries to go for the Devil Man as well. Solis are going to aggressively bomb down onto the medic. Oh, that is Pokegon. I'm not too sure if it was a drop or not, though. And they're just getting cleaned up. Daylight gonna stand on a couple of sticks, and he has the rocket jump to safety. And
that was actually lied on the favor of blue team, especially when the enemy team has the midpoint cap. It means that Prinny Pirate Plunderers have better spawns. They spawn faster.
Yep.
So that was actually very fortunate for them. It seems like the scouts are doing 1v1s right now. MGE add one, and Elky gets taken out by Killer. That was some good play. Oh, what? Lurl kicks on Pokey. What? No heals for mid. Especially with 22 seconds left onto the mid fight. Left side soldier levitated. That was some good play by the scouts there. I don't think red team is going to be able to push this out, especially with 10 seconds left. Actually, I might be wrong here.
Lo just spawns in. We got Harsh making his way to the front lines. They've got heals right now, but it's going to be really tough for them to push forward. They're going to have to desperately push, but just not enough. And this is the first point for the side of the Prettys on the scoreboard.
Yeah, that was some very that was very fortunate for blue side to get those spawns very fast. They instantly had their scouts in front lines, so they were able to cap that point. So that was good work on them.
The point gonna be on the way once again. Harsh gonna start spamming those pipes. We're gonna see a Solly straight away kill, just jumping forward. He's gonna end up punished for overstanding his welcome, but they are gonna be two players down from the side of the Korean Strelka and Daylight. The Demo Man may get spammed out. Lurl just trying his best to toss out all the damage. We've got another Solly bomb. Smiley just jumping face first into everyone, and that is so many players down for the side of ESG. And Baxter gonna have to back out. Pokey all the way in safety, grinding that Uber charge out.
Oof. I don't think he's going to be able to back up from that. Yeah, so I think that was some good play by the scouts. That was some energetic bombs from the soldiers, bombing straight into the left side of the Koreans, and then a Smiley finishing off the kill. So that was some good coordinated bomb there.
Yep, so they're going to start walking out with that Uber charge ready to go. The Prettys, of course, going to be holding on their side of the field, not too keen on pulling anything too risky off. Pokey gonna be right there, Solly gonna be jumping up top, gonna hit a couple of rockets, and we're gonna see Smiley once again just jumping face first into them. He's gonna get denied though, but he doesn't get much done, he doesn't get the force either. LK gonna get finished off shortly after. Kill gonna have some spam fest together with Daylight. Strucker gonna start standing on their point, and Uber is gonna get popped from the side of the Prettys. Pokey is still yet to pop his, and everyone is still safe and away, and they are gonna pop their new charge right now. Harsh gonna be right behind with the Solly jumping
going
forward.
For the medic.
Yeah,
seems like they're going for Eevee. Eevee needs to surf to get away here. Oh, what? He doesn't need to surf!
No way.
He doesn't need to surf! Okay, the soldier died immediately. Some good work by Smiley taking that demo man as well. So, it seems like Blue is reconverting this mid loss into a mid win. And it seems like the scout just feeding in to the enemy scout combo. That was some good cleanup work by blue team here.
Yeah, and they lost Pokey. So that is no more heals.
Oh, there's some EVs on. Oh my god! Oh no, he gets taken out by Harsh!
Where did the sticky even come from? Wow.
I think he came from mid. I think the demo man came from mid side. No, main, and then he went to connector.
Yeah, that is huge for ESG. They're gonna be able to get that huge Uber at least 40%. And Eevee's gonna start grinding his out right now as we speak. Midpoint is still in the hands of the Prinnies though. They are already at a minute and 13 counting down.
Oh, it seems like blue team is going for a 4-man sack. Mm-hmm. So this is gonna be very hard for red team.
Devil's
going
in,
to
Devil's
stop.
Spots the medic! Spots the medic! Oh, doesn't get the kill though.
Are they gonna get him?
No, they're doing cleanup. Ooh.
That's some good defense there. Actually being 4-man sack is actually very hard unless you hide inside China. I mean, that was actually just a botched push, like the jumps. So I don't know. Now it seems like they're gonna go for a forward hold again. Trying to stall time, yeah.
Got a sneaky Solly watching below. Daylight tosses out a couple of rockets, doesn't get any kills though, but does deter them from pushing up through mid. We gotta see Kill getting taken down.
Gets dropped!
Oh no, this is not looking up because Pokey has his Uber charge as well. Solly's gonna be jumping forward. We're gonna see Baxter high up. He's gonna die to the laws of gravity. Daylight gonna be down there facing off against Killer. And he's gonna pick him off. And Pokey did not even pop that Uber charge. Daylight gonna be forward, tries to get the picks down onto the demo man, but he's gonna get taken down instead with the scout scatter shots coming in. LK gonna be at the front lines this time around. They're gonna try to see if they can fight them off. Time of the side of the Korean still ticking out. They still haven't popped that Uber charge. LK gonna be right there together with his medic, facing off against
this
everyone. They finally pop it. LK once again going face first. He has to pick off the medic though, but the medic does
he
back out to spawn. And they have to start backing out. Solly's gonna be right there, but he should be punished and he should be cleaned up with LK still on the front lines. And the rest of his team should start pouring in, with Eevee starting to be healed inside of the Prinnies.
LK is 3v1ing, he's still alive for some reason!
He's 1v everyone!
What?
Oh, finally getting put into the ground! Oh, but
the
Prinnies, they're losing everyone, and Eevee has to back out again. Pokey does die though, so that is going to be the silver lining for these mid-fight exchanges. They still do have a slight add on that timer. They are going to start walking out, because they're going to get the Uber charge really soon. Provided nothing happens, or Baxter tries to come in and do anything at all, but he's gonna get punished instead, get absolutely destroyed. And Scout's gonna be right there, hiding around the corner, Strelka.
Oh, he almost gets alive. No, he actually gets taken out by Killer there, and Smiley's gonna go for a big. Oh, almost takes down the demo, but gets cleaned up. So, actually, no, he takes down the demo.
Once again, it's LK against the world. Just running around forward together with Pokey. Oh, they still got that Uber charge though, so that is something they have to worry about. So he's gonna be up top inside China waiting for some heals. And his jump got absolutely denied. I do believe
that. Yeah, this is interesting by Prinnies. They're not even aggressing the medic, even though they had add. Especially when they're playing because, okay, this is gonna be singling and push. Oh my god, Kill just kills the medic instantly. Just sat on him and Goomba'd him instant. So now this is gonna be a blue team mid, hopefully.
Yeah, Kilt just hanging back, spamming from that rock, and the Koreans with no heals at the front line, they really could not contest this at all. They're gonna have to start having some desperate plays though, because their timer is gonna start ticking down. They have to go for some serious bombs. And we see Baxter right there up on China. He may just bomb through the cliffside, and there he goes, bumps onto the rock, spots the Solly down below. He does get bounced back on the point, and he gets killed by that little sticky traps laid down, and the timer ticking down. They start capping the point. They gotta start playing around the point though. Koreans are gonna start standing on it. LK gonna get spammed out.
Yeah,
he does
no
pick
way.
Up Smiley somehow. And they just stack it and 2-2.
I think the Koreans were too slow to follow up on the soldier bombs because that created such a good distraction for the blue team that that's all they went for. And the fact that their scouts didn't use that aggressive Strelka LK push or those crazy stout duos push, I don't think that would work it out either way.
Yep, so mid fight's gonna be on the way once again. We're gonna see the demo spam coming out. Little gonna start tossing out those stickies as will Harsh, and we're gonna see some bombs coming in from the side of the Koreans jumping straight down. Baxter is gonna be able to pick up Eevee. He does go down eventually, but there's no more heals for the side of the Prinnies, but there's no more players for the side of the Koreans. Harsh trying his very best to deter anyone from pushing forward. The medic does stay alive. That is definitely the silver lining for the side of ESG. They are going to hold on to that very, very sizable Uber ad, but they do lose this midpoint.
Yeah, I mean, I don't understand their medic.
Low, spamming out those pipes, spamming down onto the other team, and LK trying to see if he can get something done. So many stickies in play at the point right now, and it's slowly going to be down!
Oh my god, amazing play by Smiley, especially with that. Oh wow, Jesus Christ. Unbelievable. That's some good bomb there.
Plus two to Smiley. And Pandemic's chest can be right there, happily grinding out that Uber charge. They do finally start that timer ticking down. Remember, whoever wins this round is gonna get this map for their team. And it's the tiebreaker round right now. Smiley gonna be jumping right there, gonna be jumping back out to get some heals. You're gonna see another bomb coming in from Kill.
He like gets airshot! Oh my god! Amazing airshot by Kill.
Yeah, and Baxter's gonna be able to pick up EV, so that is the medic down once again. I'm not too sure if it was a plus two, but that is EV dead. And Pokey gonna eat a bit of spam. Stroker gonna be right there against that demo man. And the medic whips on the pan, taunts, and he's just going down with honor. And yeah, there you go.
Smiley just keeps up aggressing the medic, and he just keeps on getting the med pick here. I mean, his success rate is pretty high now, so I think he's really hyped up. I can feel it. I can feel the calls.
Oh, yeah.
Medic!
Smiley's in, and once again doesn't quite get that rocket jump on, but he's gonna have to start backing out. He's gonna get bullied out. Scouts are gonna start making the way to the front lines. We're gonna see the scouts do the exact same thing for the Koreans, but it does look like the Prinnies have the ground on the point. They cap it, and they are gonna lose.
Baxter, does he stick in?
Oh, harsh! Just landing those double pipes. Eat your pills, Smiley. Doctor's orders.
That was actually very good. That was very impressive by the red team. They managed to clean up blue team very fast. I thought that was gonna be a blue team mid immediately because they had like the damage add. So I didn't expect that.
Harsh is just landing pipe after pipe on that scout, and he's gonna be fine. He's gonna be able to back out. Hookie is gonna be alive and fine. Eevee is gonna have slight Uber around. He's still gonna run in that stock medigun, and apparently the Koreans are just gonna be just giving up this point right now. Just regrouping the double slowly bombs. Oh, Daylight's gonna get denied, but Baxter's still alive. He's gonna have to grab that small little baby health.
Oh no, he doesn't get singled out. He's gonna get covered by the demo, the scout, the scout! The demo's actually caught in mid here! Oh my god, he gets taken out by the double scout duo here. And then Smiley gonna go aggressive on the cliffside. I think they're gonna give this up for blue team here. I mean, they have 1 minute advantage. They could take their time.
Yep, everyone just hanging back at the moment. We're gonna see Kilt once again just having his just perching up on that rock. We're gonna see Stroker running from the left side, from grass area, from creek. But nothing much getting done right now. The timer for the side of the Prinnies is gonna be ticking out in 1:49 compared to the Koreans 1:08. And this is gonna spark potential jumps coming in from Daylight. We can see him jumping forward, he's getting absolutely destroyed. Baxter jumping straight down, and Uber is gonna get forced indeed. And Pokey's still gonna be fine. He's still gonna be all the way back at spawn. Harsh is still gonna be alive. Everyone's fine. They got the Uber charge ready to go, so counter push potentially once everyone spawns in. Kilt gonna be waiting in that sneaky spot. So waiting to see if he can get any sneaky plays. He does get spotted out though. Kilt is gonna get denied. And the rest of the team's gonna be fine. We're gonna see Low right there. Can any sneaky traps get any kills though? The answer is potentially no. Everyone seems to be able to make it out.
Yeah, this guy's getting singled out here on the left side. They're all feeding, they're all bleeding out their players. They need to leave here or either sack their entire team for their medic. So it seems like Smiley's gonna go in for the medic. High success rate. Will he get the kill? No, he doesn't. Demo going in. Oh my god, he takes down the demo man as well. Oh my god, excellent play by Lyril. I hope he killed the medic though. That would have been preferable.
Yeah, Pokey's still up and well, still holding onto the Uber charge. Balls of steel not popping at all. And they're holding really far forward this time around, watching their flanks. Got a scout right there. We've got a Solly potentially going to get double bomb. Daylight going to have to get bullied out by the scouts who are just walking in. Pandemic going to be coming in from the right side under the cliff. And Uber Charge is going to be ready to go. Doesn't look like he's going to be the Uber scout of choice. It's just going to be Mouse running straight forward. He's going to pluck LK out of the sky. We're going to see him just walk straight forward, potentially get an Uber pop. They're trying to cap this point first, but the Solly's just going to be jumping forward, getting that force down onto EV. And the Uber is going to get
better Uber
as well. Yep, much better Uber for the side of EV. And Smiley's gonna be right there, jumping straight onto the main.
Oh, they're pincering cliffside! Ooh. The demo jumped and the soldier jumped. Actually, very unusual double bomb. Mm-hmm. I thought there were gonna be a double soldier bomb, but actually it's a demo and a roamer bomb. So, very weird bombs here.
And yeah, right now it is just gonna be killed, spamming through that. Oh, the left side getting lots of damage. Smiley comes in to help him out, and that is the Solly right there making it out alive. Okay, they're just losing players.
No,
Killer and Smiley are down. Baxter does go down as well.
The demo's gonna get caught here.
Oh, no.
He gets baited.
Oh, Pokey is.
Oh my god, amazing turnaround here.
Oh, 30 seconds Baxter's, coming down.
Daylight's gonna go for the medic! Eevee! Oh my god, amazing dodges by Eevee. That was actually a good play by Killed. He was able to convert those two down with two down of equal sides. So he traded both of his skills for the enemy's player. Oh, it seems like Smiley's gonna go with aggressive bombs here. 30 seconds left. It would be preferable if Lurl put stickies on the point because that would be what they were gonna go for right now.
Yep.
Wait, but Eevee has 80%, so it seems like they're gonna play back. They're gonna wait for Uber, but Red Team is not gonna let them have that. Wait, actually no, they're backing out for some reason. Yeah, Eevee's gonna have it.
They cannot
afford
to do this. They cannot afford to give them space, and Eevee's gonna pop that Uber charge and just bully the Koreans out. The Koreans have to cut this for as long as they can. The scouts are doing their very best. LK down to get a little point. He needs to pick up players for
blue
his team.
Blue team is all standing on point. All of blue team is standing on point. This is a massive misplay. This could be a very
Strelka! He's just walking in, picking off players one by one! Strelka is going huge! He has to pick up Pandemic. Pandemic is right there. He needs to get the heals from Pokey. Healing him. Has the medigun up his ass, but Pokey's not going to be able to heal him off. Oh, the demo man comes in. Can he save the medic? Yes, he can!
You need to jump in! You need to go in, boys!
Oh, they have to stand on it.
Oh my god!
Oh, the demo man's in. The Solis are going to start desperately jumping the point. And they get that destroyed!
Jesus Christ, that was insanely close.
Baxter jumps
from the backside.
Oh!
I told you, bro. It's gonna be a 3-2.
Wow!
Instantly called. That was a very close win. I actually thought blue team was gonna win that, especially with that Uber ad, but the mere fact that their entire team was standing on a point gave their soldiers, the red team soldiers, actually give them so much damage potential and their demo as well. And that gave red team the ability to recuperate. But in the end, blue team was just much more better in the scrappy fights.
Yeah, the scrappy fights indeed. That last point defense coming out from blue, that desperate attempt to hold on to that point. Holy crap, we've got the logs up on screen right now. Top damager is going to be Pandemic with a whopping 370 damage. LK not too far behind with 351 and Baxter at 327. Top fragger is going to be Pandemic with 43 frags. LK with 42. And Killer with 38 kills. Holy crap.
Yeah, definitely LK and Pandemic doing a lot of work. You can see, especially in mid-fights, I don't think some people would mention this, but Pandemic would actually help out and reinforce the left side. That actually helped them save most of their rounds. Mm-hmm. Because at the beginning of the game, you would see Red Team or the Koreans would abuse the flank so hard that they will actually lose Uber ad situations just because of it. And with the mere fact that like Pandemic is reinforcing the flank is actually giving them such a big boost on defensive maneuvering that the demo and the soldier can just bomb in straight in. Some good plays there.
So what happening now? Just like everyone's in spec?
I don't know. it seems like it's a pug. So
everyone rolled. Gonna wait for people to start choosing. Oh, but holy crap, that was close.
Yeah, that almost went this a big disaster for blue team. They like all five players, I think, the medic, the demo, the soldier, and the scout, both of the scouts were standing on the point, and then there was just one soldier shooting one spot and all of them were taking damage.
that was actually very, very close.
I can't believe blue team managed to win that out. I actually thought the red team would win that, especially with that Strelka momentum boost.
Oh, Strelka was huge, just scattershotting everyone down, and then suddenly the Solis appear, and oh, it's so epic. These are the type of games we want to cast. I'm so happy that we are covering this right now. For those of you who are just joining us, very good evening. Welcome to the AsiaFortress Cup Season 13 Div 1 Upper Bracket Semi-Finals. It is the Prinny Pirate Plunderers facing off against Eat Sleep Game. First map cough product went to the PPPs. They've got it 3-2 with a huge comeback from 2-0. They bring it just three rounds, one after the other. And they are going to be able to grab this first map. Second map of the night is going to be CP Process. So we're just going to have to see how they play this through. This is really exciting.
I still can't get over the fact that blue team did not get a single kill with their Uber and still managed to win. Even at that positional misplay. How were you able to win with that? I don't understand.
Yeah, and Matt props to ESG as well. I mean, they kited that Uber. Strelka stayed alive, and like, even though he had some of his teammates dying, and then he just solo scout medic and just faced off against absolutely everyone. Definitely the scouts for the side of ESG are just pulling their weight really hard.
Yeah, that's some aggressive big plays there, especially with Strelka coming from behind. Mm-hmm. Oh my god, he managed to pick down two players, and that was like disastrous for blue team. Ooh. I still didn't get why the Koreans didn't go for the force there.
Yeah.
I think they went back and let blue team recuperate from that. Mm-hmm. So that might have been the make it or break it moment there.
That is massive for the Prinny. So of course it's all gonna be on the line right now for the ESG players. They have to cap this. They have to take this map if they want to push things into the tiebreaker map, which is gonna be CP Snakewater. We are in the playoffs right now, so there will be golden caps. And if they tie, we will be pushed into a golden cap, and then whoever wins, of course, will take the map home. So ESG need to get this map if they want to stay in the upper bracket. And of course, you know, the Prinnies, all they need is to take this map and they can stay in that upper bracket, pushing ESG down into the lower bracket. Of course, it's not the end of the world. It's just week one of four the upper brackets. Whoever goes down to the lower brackets will face off against the other team, of which I cannot remember who. It's DLLM and... who is the other team again?
8%%?
For Div 2? 8%%?
Wait, I'm... I'm currently brain dead right now because
no, it was DLLM and shit. I just did it yesterday.
Nokorimon.
Yes. So lower bracket will be Nokorimon right now, waiting for the person who will be pushed down, be it be it the Prinnies or ESG. So we're just gonna have to wait and see who stays in the upper bracket face off against DLLM, and who gets pushed down face off against Nokorimon. So everyone's inside the server just waiting for Eevee and Pandemic to ready up. Do you have any predictions for this map?
I think this is going to be a Korean win.
Actually,
last season, we called this a Korean bomb, where they would basically just sack in their two soldiers blindly. They would always do this in the middle. They would literally just sack in their two soldiers, mm-hmm. and then the scouts would clean up. They would sack them probably in the health pack area and then land near sewer. That's what's going to happen right now. It's going to be a red team. This is going to be a Korean win.
Yeah, it seems like that's what they've been doing on product, and it seems to work out for them, you know. And they definitely trust Strelka and LK to do the cleanup, which they have been doing multiple times. So this is really gonna be interesting. These mids gonna see maybe what if they do double Sully fast rollout to mid and just bomb them. Who knows? We're going to be going live after a couple of restarts. Once again, for those of you who are only just joining us, a very good evening. Welcome to the stream. It is the AsiaFortress Cup Season 13 Div 1 Upper Bracket Semi-Finals. It is the Prinny Pirate Plunderers facing off against Eat Sleep Game. The Prinnies, of course, are going to be on the blue team, and the ESG players are going to be on red, and we are going to be going live. Going to follow Lurl for his rollout this time around, and we're just going to have to wait and see what happens this week.
I am 100% assuring you this is going to be a Korean bomb where they double bomb and high bomb here. Oh,
Smiley's already going to start gaining that high ground. And then he's going to start getting a little bit of capture time up on the point. Kill's going to follow suit. Going to get that solid double rocket jump back onto that baby.
Here we go, the double bomb! Oh. Never mind, they get baited! Oh, what? The rocket jump! No, they're getting baited by the soldiers into their scouts! They're getting grinded here! And it seems like the scout took 100 there. There's some good damage by Kill.
Pandemic's going down. We got three players down from the side of the Prinnies. Everyone's still up apart from Harsh. Baxter jumping forward, and he just chases them out through the sewers. And
that was actually very smart. The Korean bomb baited them into doing damage to their soldiers, and then when they rocket jumped out, they just get grinded by the scouts there, waiting for them at the health pack. Oh, they're gonna push on one man down? Okay, this is interesting. Ooh. The soldier gets singled out on Choke with 100 HP.
They're doing double Sully bombs as well for the side of the Prinny's Baxter.
They need to force it. Ooh. The Mets caught a Choke! They need to aggress here. The red team needs to aggress. The Mets caught already.
Oh, he makes it out.
What? Yeah. He survives? That should have never happened.
Hokey just walks out of there. And yes, the Prinnies, man, they're just gaining some ground, gaining the front lines. Both teams, of course, are still holding on to the Uber charge, so I want to see some Solly bombs coming in from either side. Does look like Smiley's gonna get his full buff before he does anything too risky. Right beside the wall, double rocket jump straight down, spots the medic, tries to get the force, jumps up once again. Demoman has to do something, gets an air pipe! And he's gonna be at 8 health, grabs the baby health pack, but he's gonna get punished for attempting anything at all. And it's probably gonna be another reset.
This is gonna be a counter sack from Daylight, probably. Yep. Oh, they're pushing in? No, actually, I think they're gonna distract for the soldier to bomb in. Oh, but the flank is being worked hard here. With two things on. What?
Daylight.
Oh my god, they get taken out. Daylight and Stroka.
Gonna get punished inside that IT. Baxter gonna be jumping from behind. Spots the man gets the drop! Oh, that is the Uber pop though for the side of ESG. They pop that Uber charge way out. We've got people still behind them. Soli and Scout inside sewers. They're gonna have to bully them out. Soli gets killed, gonna be right there. Whips out that escape plan, but he's getting absolutely destroyed. Smiley is still alive though. The splash damage is gonna be enough to take him down. Scout's gonna be running in. Baxter has to reload to get something done. The medic is still alive. A little
bit low. They're gonna try and clean up.
Just wiping the floor right now. We're gonna see Hush.
This scout is doing so much damage. The control point has been he takes out the demo. Wait, what? Red team hasn't capped mid? Huh?
All this time they were holding mid and they haven't.
This might
capped.
Give blue team the leeway to forward.
Yeah, they still got a couple of people inside forward right now.
Oh, they don't.
Yeah, they back spawn. It's fine. They're gonna hold on to the spire. We got sniper play right now. Pandemic gonna be on that sniper role with killer gonna be on that engineer. And he's gonna get that shadow door open from door one. Spots the scout, spots the Soli. He doesn't get any shots though. Soli might be walking on through. Has to watch his head.
Alright, they're gonna push shutter, I think, with a scout and soldier Uber. So this might end up well. Actually, yeah, the entire team is in left here. And the soldier's gonna jump into the soldier and the demo. What? He's getting singled out. He gets taken out by killer. Oh my god, what a feat. And it seems like red team is taking control of that cap point. What? They're reconverting?
Yep, they're gonna have to play this very carefully because Eevee is still alive and holding on to that 72% recharge. Joker just stands on it! Alright, there you go.
That was actually a big bomb by Daylight. Like, the entire team of Blue literally looked at Daylight, and that made the other scouts gave them space to walk onto the point there. So that was some good play.
Yeah, and Lil didn't get his stickies with Stroker just shooting at them while standing on the point. And mid-fight's gonna be on the way once again. Daylight just jumping up top. Baxter, of course, gonna follow suit very, very soon. Potentially see another double Soli bomb. Yeah, Baxter.
Oh, no, he gets to die!
Catches a sticky with his forehead. He's gonna get taken down. And Smiley is gonna go down as well. Double Soli tread. Kill's gonna be fine, waiting for some heals. And the Soli just jumping face first into the medic!
Oh,
Daylight is gonna
get punished. He takes out the medic!
After picking up that medic, so no heals for the side of Pretties.
They need to sack. They need to sack for the enemy medic here.
Strelka.
They need to kill the medic here. This is the top priority pick, so they could equal. Oh, they couldn't. I think Smiley's gonna go for this.
Look,
I actually believe Smiley's
just
gonna go
waiting for his medic to spawn. They have to grind out this Umi charge. Yeah. They're just gonna hold on to last.
I don't think they could.
Smiley's waiting for that Umi.
Yeah, he's gonna go for it. He has to go for it.
There you go. Jump straight down.
He's gonna go
for the medic.
100% accuracy!
Straight into his face!
Oh my god, such patient play. He doesn't even go for the air shot. He just wants to go for the secured kill. Although that was beside this wall. So this could be a blue mid. Possibly a blue mid. Oh, actually with that scout down, that would actually signal the push for blue team to go into choke. Hopefully Eevee doesn't die in sewer.
Baxter's in sewer right now.
Oh no. Oh no, kill spots him! That's good, that's good. He knows that someone's in sewer, so he's gonna fight him probably.
Yep, scout spots him, gonna pull him out. Grabs that health back and he's just rocket jumping out of there. Ooh, Daylight's gonna be going down though. He tries to go in for some sneaky plays. We're gonna see the demo man Harsh right there. Gonna get spammed up by killed at choke.
Oh, he's 40 HP!
All that spam! Ooh.
This might be a second push even. Especially with that scout and demo, soldier and demo down. This could be a second push. Kill's already rocket jumping in with 148 HP. No fear. Oh, never mind. Red, the Koreans are fearful.
Stroka.
That's why they get taken down.
Stroka dancing around those stickies. Finally gonna get punished with that roll, I believe. Or direct from Lil. And they are gonna be able to grab this spire. They got their full Uber charge. They can walk straight in. They only got an engineer and they just pop it onto Pandemic, who's just walking face first. Gonna be shiny, spot that sentry gun, they have to take it down low, gonna be able to make short work of that sentry gun. We've got some Solis up inside secret, we're gonna see them start playing around the point though. The scouts are already on it, they're not doing anything to contest this. And scouts trying their very best, we're gonna see LK, are they apparently holding last? LK scattershotting killer out of the air, Pandemic with his heals though, but he's not gonna be able to do much with that. Low just spamming on the point.
Here.
They do pick up Pokey though, so that is gonna be the silver lining. LK is out for blood, but he's not gonna be pushed too far out. Successful defense though for the side of ESG.
Yeah, it actually took them so long for them to get picks there. So that I think that was the crux of the push.
Mm-hmm.
So now they're gonna try and build this Uber out very fast, and then hopefully they're gonna go to Boiler, not straight into Shutter. What? Pandemic gets taken down, gets caught.
Oh, that's a rip. Down.
Oh, this is bad. Especially when Eevee has 100.
Yeah, potentially a sack though coming from Pandemic. He might be coming back as something else, but you know, with your team having full Uber charge right now, maybe it might have been a misplay.
Oh no, they didn't. Oh, they spot the sticky. That almost that almost dropped Eevee. they're taking their sweet time here, and Toki's already at 76%.
Yeah.
So
they really.
I don't think this is gonna be ending.
Sentry Guard's gonna be right there, level 2, and Lowell should be able to make short work of that. They retain inside spawn though, so they should be able to come out with that full Uber charge. They're stacking on the point though. You have to do something about it, but they're just not doing enough.
Red team trying to be a little bit greedy there, trying to kite that Uber as best as they can so they could get more kills, but that ended up causing them their point.
Yeah. Bit of a shame. Maybe they could have stayed out to try and kite that Uber, because Pokey was already at like 95.
Oh, it seems like the soldier's really aggro. Sees a soldier, gets a good rocket on him. It's just a double
Bax
soldier
is going in.
Battle.
Up on that high ground.
I think there's gonna be the Korean bomb.
Yep.
The Korean bomb? What?
Like,
oh, he misses that! Oh, no! What?
He's gonna get denied. Oh, but Baxter's still in though. Baxter knows where the medic is. He's gonna grab that baby health pack, spots the Sully up top. He's gonna get denied for his jump, and the Koreans are just gonna start backing out. They're getting bullied all the way through choke. And, yeah.
What? This could actually be a red mid. They're gonna try and fight this, I think. I hope. Oh no, Stroker gets fed!
LK is in, man. LK is in deep, getting some heals before he decides to push
forward.
Yeah,
they're gonna fight this
Solly bomb straight down onto the medic, getting the force! Eevee does not have his yet though. Pandemic is gonna be right there. LK is out for blood, but he's not gonna-
Soldier's gonna go chasing. Baxter's gonna chase the medic and Boiler, I think. Baxter's on the hunt. No, he gets distracted. He's afraid of the soldier and the scout. I think he's gonna get caught here. Yes, he gets caught. I mean, it's still good because like red team has that midpoint. Mm-hmm. I think they're gonna push in right now. They're gonna come in. It doesn't matter. The Uber's been popped. They're gonna go straight onto the demo man here. Gets taken out. So I think they're gonna push again. No, actually no. Especially when that cap point is in. I think they're gonna stack it. Try to defend it.
Yep. So just waiting on that Uber charge to get up for Pokey. This may spark a dry push though from the side of the Prinny, because they know they don't have it yet, so they may try to see if they can do something, not anything at all, see if they can send some Sollies in, but it does look like they're just going to play a little bit passively with everyone hanging back. Smiley standing on the roof and killed on the crates.
Oh, he's going to go for the bomb!
No, he failed his jump! He failed his jump!
All right.
But he's still going to go in anyway! Spots the medic! What? Oh, scatter shots from Stroka is going to take him down for that.
He does not deserve if he actually got the medic. He had 140 HP, yeah. Do not as Roamer.
They're gonna start walking out.
It seems like, what? Baxter's gonna go. What? They're gonna go IG? What? What is this? Double Soldier Korean bomb? I'm actually very.
Swan, he's in on the medic again! He's gonna get the force. That is cute, getting the force down to the medic. Eevee's gonna have his really soon, so they really should not be walking first into this. And Uri's gonna get popped. There you go.
The
medic
they're
may get caught
point.
Out. LK has to deny this, but he's gonna get destroyed. And Lil has his sight from the medic, picks up the scout, and they just.
Oh,
the Solly's gonna chase though. Smiley.
Oh, but Harsh, yeah. Harsh is behind. He's gonna go for the medic! The soldier and the demo is gonna go for the medic. Hopefully, he hits a pipe! Oh. That was close. Oh no! What? Daylight goes from behind! he gets Eevee! That was actually very surprising. I thought Eevee was already alive. He's gonna push last, but never mind.
Wow. Alright, so Pokey's up, but he's not healing anyone yet. That means equal Ubers for both sides! Alright, Pokey eventually starts building his charge, but that's a little bit too late. And equal Ubers are gonna be up for both sides. Apparently, slight add, but Nick.
What? Stroko's in? I think he's gonna die here. He should die. That's LK. He should get punished, yeah.
Pokey
he dies.
Just lost all his Uber add. Why?
I think it's because his team didn't fetch him, so I think that cost them the ad. But I don't understand why LK went in there. I think he wanted to fight that.
Yeah.
I mean, that was weird. He wanted to sack, but he also didn't want to sack, so he just stayed in choke area, tried to 4v1, so that didn't end up well for him.
Yep, so we may see another Smiley ball. We see him getting the buffs, waiting for that full 300.
Jump beef
which
incoming.
He is not getting until now, and
no one's watching IT, I think.
He's still waiting for the buff, going in right now.
He's
trying to see if he can get the medic once again, spots him! He's gonna get destroyed this time around, gonna get punished. Lil tries to do a follow-up, but he's just not gonna be able
to. They need
to
play back
spam.
Now. Yeah, they're playing back right now. What demo? Their demo's getting caught here! Oh my god, he doesn't get taken out, and then Stroko... actually, LK is on the left side. They're trying to send me dry push here. They need to just pop Uber here. They need to trade here. There's four people on chill. Their demo's gonna get caught. Oh no, the demo's dead. And then the Uber's been raided. What? Oh my god, Badger gets levitated into the air. Oh my god, great play from the scouts. Just good that. What's my still going in? Why?
There's so much going on.
The IT guys just went in because they thought that the choke guys from Koreans were gonna go in, but they get caught out. Actually, Pandemic gets traded here, and then the scout is going behind. He's going against a medic. Oh, he gets taken out. Why are they doing this? This isn't an MGE server.
Yeah, it's just full on DM right now. Pokey was insanely low when he popped the recharge. I think he was like one health. Oh, kill this down. Gotta see Lil start spamming out his sticks. Quickie Bomb launcher Lil. And they're just gonna hold back on Spire, wait for the recharge before they decide to do anything.
They could actually hold this. They could kite this Uber, and then they would be able to push with Uber as well. So they could leapfrog here. Actually, Red Team's not gonna pop immediately here, so this might actually end well for Red. So they're gonna pop first. The scout gets piped here. The demo might get caught. Actually, no, the scouts are going behind. He's gonna get taken out there though. Hopefully, no, he gets Daylight. What?
Strucker's still in. Tries to get the pick down onto the demo, but he's gonna have to face off against Pandemic, who has much more health. And he's gonna get taken down, and they still want to fight this apparently. Devilman and the rest of his team are in. LK gonna be able to pick up Pandemic. Harsh landing a couple of meaty stick shots. Sorry, meaty pipes right there. The medic may get caught out. Eevee is really low. The roller!
Oh,
just not enough damage.
He almost got cut out. That was actually very confusing. This isn't a DM server, guys. Like, there was fighting in IT, there was fighting in choke, there was fighting in
fighting
mid,
everywhere.
There was fighting on second. This is Highlander, right?
Yeah.
Is this Highlander? Like, I feel like I'm casting a Highlander game.
Oof, the scores are still tied 1-1 though, and the Prinnies are currently defending their last point. Solis are going to be watching the right side kill. Does look like he wants to peek on through. Spots the medic right there, but the Stickies are going to take it down to 100 health. We're going to have Pandemic on that sniper roll once again. Watching that rollout, swapping out to the boiler side. And right now no one's
I have a feeling Pandemic's going to get fed. I have a very big feeling.
Yeah, he's like 53 health waiting for some arrows.
Especially with Red Team not aggressively holding Boiler, this might actually be ending badly for Red Team. If Pandemic can go for a pixel shot here. Actually, Pokey in a very weird position. I've never actually seen this. This is actually very peculiar. I mean, the reason why you don't this is the moment they peek rollout, you're already dead.
Yeah. He's just standing there, looking at him.
I mean, at least he doesn't have to work for a spy.
Yeah.
That's a good thing about it, but you know, standing still when there's an enemy sniper, I don't think I agree.
Yeah, Pandemic gets a headshot onto Daylight, but Daylight's gonna be fine with the medic. You gotta be able to arrow him back.
Look at the killed secondary.
Shotgun?
Oh, but Smiley gets taken out. No, he has the battalion's backup.
Oh, Strauk is down. Headshot from Pandemic. Battalion's backup up on killed.
I remember this.
Both sides. Pandemic's gonna start picking
Pandemic's gonna go for a second. He's gonna peek roll out.
Dangerous,
yeah, he's
dangerous.
Gonna go for a rollout because like the medic is standing still on second.
Oh, once the shutter opens, he may be able to get the headshot down onto Pokey. Pokey just crouches! He can't find his head! He picks up LK though.
You should just peek rollout, dude. What is this, a Highlander game?
No, we got Stroker on Sniper this time around as well.
I think Killed is just recharging his battalion's backup. I remember Killed playing the battalion's backup in the Div 2 Grand Finals, and it didn't end well for him. This might spell the doom for blue team here. So I don't know. So he's gonna open Shudder here. He's gonna try and peek. He almost gets a shot onto Medic.
He got a hit shot on Pandemic though. Stroker does land a shot though. Not enough to kill Pandemic. Pandemic with that overheals going down. Stroker trying to flank from the boiler room. He may get the sights
down. Yeah, the sniper is gonna go boiler.
Oh, doesn't get a kill.
Eevee's hiding here. He knows that there's a sniper and he's trying to hide here.
Debbie's waiting for that shutter to open. The engineer's gonna do it for him. Doesn't get any shots at all.
Wait, why is there a teleporter there? Oh, they're gonna go for a telefrag? What? Actually, I think they're gonna go for a telefrag.
Did they actually get it? Wow.
I feel like, yeah, they're gonna go for the telefrag here.
Yep, finally we're gonna see some off-classing coming out in terms of Kilt running Spy. This is what
Why?
We wanna see.
Why Kilt? I don't understand.
Dialek gonna be down. Kilt.
Kilt's gonna go behind.
Yep.
He sees the medic! The medic's on!
Decoat, the decoat!
The medic's on!
Oh!
Oh, he goes for... oh,
oh
no.
No,
the butter knife! The butter knife! Why is Kilt on Spy? I do not understand. Kilt has no experience on Spy at all.
There are two players down though for the side of the Prinnies, but they do still have that sentry gun up.
Yeah.
Strucker once again trying
it
to
doesn't
that
matter
forward.
Though, because they can just trade here. So it's okay if they lose two players, they can just trade.
Strucker has his sights on the medic. The medic just needs to walk out. Oh, gives away his position. SMG, some Call of Duty action. Smiley gonna get
oh,
caught
what?
Out.
Smiley. What? They like get taken out as well. Oh, it seems
Hush
like
going down. Everyone's going down. Everyone's gonna get popped.
Oh my god.
Much better Uber for the side of the Prinnies. And they pop it. And it's definitely gonna be a successful defense. They got still got that sentry up. They haven't done anything to take it down. And yeah, Solly's not gonna get taken down. Pokey is somehow.
Cypress or Shudder! Wait. Cypress or Shudder!
Is still in.
I think he's gonna go for a back. What is he doing? What is he? I think he's waiting for the spawns here. I think he's spawn capping. Oh, he misses the shot. He's gonna get caught here. Hopefully. Oh, he almost gets the medic.
Strucker just walking out right there, tries to get the headshot. Oh dear me, they do recap the spy after a lengthy last
spy. There's a spy under medic! There's a spy under medic! Oh, he gets caught up! Little Sticky jumps out and then accidentally kills Daylight! What is this game? Is this a Highlander game?
Solis
oh
are
my
in
god,
low.
Max is
yep, he's gonna get taken down. Oh, man.
I think Daylight wanted to have revenge on Kilt running spy there. I think he wanted to show I'm a better spy even though I never played spy in my entire life.
And they push them all the way back to their spire, and EV's gonna have his Uber charge up really, really soon. We see Pokey at 63, that's not gonna be enough, because all they have to do is just walk in straight away, which is exactly what they're gonna be doing. Pandemic is gonna be a shiny scout of choice. Has his eyes
oh
on the
my god!
Man. Strelka just headshots down low. Counter push is gonna start coming back out. They're
oh,
gonna
but
have
there's
the
a soldier in panic room! There's a soldier in panic room, he might get the medic!
He's bombing straight down!
Oh my god! Oh, he drops the medic! Ooh. Oh my god, crazy bomb! That was some sick play by Kilt. He already knew that his team was gonna lose, so he baited his team. Typical Kilt fashion. Everyone knows that Kilt baits his team, that's why every team hates him. So, still, the fact remains that he gets the pick, and it saved his team from losing mid here. What? LK just go straight into choke again. I don't understand why the scouts just keep on pushing choke, but they don't get punished now.
Yeah,
so
once
that's
again, no
good.
One's watching. No one goes back to fetch Pokey, and Eevee's gonna be able to have that really sizable Uber ad. So it may be an easy spire push again for the side of the Prinnies, unless some sneaky player comes out for the side of ESG. All they need to do is send Baxter in to do a couple of rocket jumps and maybe get.
Yeah, they're gonna push in, I think.
Yeah, it looks like they're gonna start just walking straight away once they have their full charge.
Alright, they need to get forced there. Spider's just gonna bomb in! What is this? Everyone's looking up against air pipe! Oh my god!
Smiley.
That was a sick air pipe.
Huge denial.
He just sent them flying. He was like a NASA rocket.
Kilt just standing on the rock trying to see if he can spam down those rockets, and the main Pokey just catching rockets with his forehead. Definitely not recommended. Kilt waiting for some buffs.
It seems like the flank is working hard here, spamming the hard, the IT side, but Pandemic is there with the buff. It seems like the scouts are 2v1ing. The soldier is doing a lot of damage, preventing those scouts from just walking in forward, but Daylight gets caught out by the two soldier IT combo. Okay,
Smiley's
gonna go IT.
Smiley's gonna try to jump the medic straight away. Can he get denied again? He gets. Yeah, he does get denied. So that's good. Silver lining for Pokey. Pokey is gonna get taken down to 34 health somehow! 10 13!
He doesn't want to pop. He's 11 HP and he doesn't care. The scouts are going in an IT. If he gets shot even once, I don't think that's gonna be very good for Pokey.
He's fine. He's fine right now. His health is going
down. Oh, he gets sticky! He's 67 now! He can't take any more spam or he's the moment he sees one guy, he's gonna instantly force. What? Daylight gets taken out.
Again,
already at
Pandemic's in. Pandemic's trying to get some sneaky plays.
Yeah, they have to go for this. Especially with the stalemate and Daylight down, they need to aggress fast and quick. Oh, but it seems like... Oh! Kilt's going in? Okay, Kilt is going to go.
Tries to get the shot! Oh
my god!
Whips up the shotgun.
Pokey just doesn't want to pop Uber!
Okay, just being really stubborn. Just holding on to that Uber. Over his dead body, he says.
Oh, the scouts, I think, are gonna go aggressive. Never mind. Red team needs to sack someone here, or at least work IT very, very hard with their demo, man, because it seems like until red team tries to aggress, I think blue team is just gonna be content, like, sacking in their players left and right.
Eventually, they're gonna get a pick or a force onto Pokey. Hash is gonna eat a couple of damage to his face, arrows gonna be tossed in his direction, he's gonna be fine. I'm surprised we're not seeing any bombs coming out from the Koreans though. So far it's just been the Prinnies constantly sending in Smiley, who has finally made his way back to the front lines. He's gonna start getting his buffs again, and he's gonna start coming for his jumps again, but are they pushing
IT,
from IT?
There's a fight. They're pushing from IT, 6-man IT? Question mark? What is it? Oh, they're just aggressing here, they're gonna try. Yeah, that's a good play by them, especially with the stalemate, but leaving your demo alone on choke, I think that would be very undesirable. But they need to try and risk here because, oh, it seems like killed might lose. Oh, he gets taken out by LK and this might push. Oh no! Pokey gets played by Lurl!
What?
He drops the Uber, doesn't want to pop, huh? Get dropped, kid! Never mind. So it seems like red team needs to force the blue medic here. It seems, yeah, it is gonna happen right now. Stroka gonna go for the bomb onto the medic, but DV not popping with it. 150 HP, didn't get even hit once. Actually, just got grazed.
Wow. So, how did the pipe even get Pokey? What was it? Random spam, and they're just gonna.
Oh, the heavy weapon.
Yeah, they don't care. They just pop the Uber charge. Heavy's already dead. Stickies are in play on the point. Doesn't really matter when you're shiny. Medic's gonna be in all alone without the Uber, so it doesn't really matter anymore. 2-1.
I mean, he doesn't want to pop, so he'd rather drop, right?
Oh my goodness.
I mean, that was
just
really
eating that spam.
Lucky by Lurl. I think that pipe was actually intended for the scout, but Toki accidentally eats it. Oh,
place.
Actually, he gets denied. This might signal the Korean bomb once again. Revitalize Korean bomb. Mm-hmm. Seems like it's gonna happen. Korean bomb incoming. Oh, it's not sinking.
Baxter! Oh, that dirty rocket onto that scout midair. Daylight gonna be a little bit low. He's gonna have to wait for some heals.
Oh my god.
IT. Scout right there. Once again, Baxter just waiting for more heals before he decides to do anything. Potentially get some people to jump forward. The Solis are just getting all that high ground. Smiley once again trying to get that air shot. Gonna get denied with that scatter shot. Killed. Gonna be jumping forward once again. Tries to see if he can land any rockets.
Oh, he gets jumped. He jumps into a scout. This is very bad for kill. He's gonna get singled out here. Did you see?
EV's down. Yeah, they're doing cleanup right now. The only person up is gonna be the Demo Man, Low, and Pandemic stuck inside sewers. And,
Their medic needs to not be forced here. So they need to be very methodical. They need to clear out that sewer side. They need to kill that Demo Man here.
Oh.
Okay, so there's another Demo Man in sewer. He needs to be taken out because if their medic gets forced here, he's gonna go for the bomb. He hits the wall! Lurl! What is
bumps
that?
His head,
bomb jump?
Falls to the ground. Full Uber charge. Potential easy last point push for the side of ESG. We already got an engineer up.
There's no way. There's no way red team is gonna botch this push. With the demo and the scout down, this is impossible to botch.
Yeah, they're going in straight away. Okay, it's gonna be shiny, but they've got a pyro. Comp blasting them away, the sentry gun is still up though. They have to do something about the sentry gun, it's still up on the right side. LK gonna start stepping on a point. And Lil right there, Solly bomb straight onto EV, who's currently still alive! Doesn't matter anymore, they tied a score 2-2.
If EV actually survived, I mean, if the mere fact that EV survived that bomb, that was actually really that was actually really impressive. He actually surfed that to the rail thingy and that point. So I mean, nice try.
4 minutes and 16 seconds counting down. Whoever wins the next point is gonna take it, seeing as to how they've been playing so far. They're gonna be a little bit more passive.
It seems like Kill's trying to do the same thing. Oh, what? The soldiers are just Korean bombing! Oh no, homing missiles everywhere! Daylight takes out Eevee!
Oh no. Oh no, the cleanup.
Discounts.
Oh. Only person up.
This is the Korean bomb. He needs to die, yes. This is the Korean bomb at its finest. It's like you're playing Call of Duty and you're on a 6 kill streak and the Predator missile just comes in.
Clean up crew. They cap this midpoint. They should be able to grab Spy, no problem. I don't know why they
didn't. Oh, Spy's gonna go for the big bomb! He's on the floor. No, he drops him again! They're just ruining Pokey's stats! Someone help this man! He's just dropping left and right. I understand that Poki doesn't want to drop there or even pop, because if he pops, I mean, it's over for the... Oh, but the soldiers are actually cleaning up blue team here. They need to take down more players. Oh, it's just LK and Stroka.
They need to rush the medic. They need to rush EV.
They're gonna rush
LK
the medic.
LK's in. EV with the Ubisoft tries to get anything done.
Oh, Stroka, good play by it.
Stroka decides to cap the point for his team.
That was actually very smart. I mean, I would have preferred for both of them to rush the medic. Stroka! Oh no! Oh no!
He gives him the 25!
Oh, no, that's really bad. This is gonna be a sad day for the Koreans here, especially with the top dog dying there. This might be a very hard... Especially with 2 minutes up, I mean... Oh, what? Spider's going in, sacking into four players? What is this questionable bomb? Wait, he survives? Never mind. I was actually very dumb. They pop Uber onto the sewer side and Spider gets taken down there. That's actually a questionable bomb there. It seems like red team is ready to contest here.
Oh.
Kill getting caught in the air.
Eevee's down again!
Jumped into Eevee. Daylight just assassinated.
Oh, harsh!
Jesus Christ, someone save these medics. I mean, come on, their stats are basically just broken right now.
Harsh! Harsh's pipes are so crisp. So crispy.
It's gonna be a blue... Hopefully there's gonna be a red team push, and then it's gonna
defense.
Be a win for them.
No,
and
no, they pop their Ruby charge. Oh, they have to kill them. They have to get some capture time up.
What
on
is
the
this?
Point.
What is this? No way, they're losing this.
They have
there's
to
no way, right?
There
they're
is
two
no
down, and then they just
way.
Pop Uber. Yeah,
there you
no,
go.
There's no way.
Wow.
I have a bad feeling that red team is not even gonna fight mid. I don't know. I might be wrong.
Ooh.
With 1 minute and 20 seconds remaining. Oh, actually, they want to fight mid. This is interesting.
They should delay them as long as they can. And there they are. Mid fight's going to be on the way. Kill's going to be jumping up top, straight down into the solely, straight down into the demo.
They're just aggressive.
Oh, he's down.
That's a Korean bomb. They just stole the strat. Oh, Harsh just annihilates Smiley with that air pipe. Some good play there. And it seems like this is going to be a.
They've got the two scouts in the front
line. Yeah,
Demi tries to go behind them, but he's gonna get taken down.
Eevee,
scout's gonna be capturing
just
the point.
Go back
Baxter
to spawn.
Going straight deep, not able to land the rockets down onto Killer, but he's gonna be fine.
They need to get out. They need to get out. They're gonna get caught here. Yeah. What? He gets a demo. Are they gonna fight this?
Oh,
yeah, they have to
Baxter
fight this. With 40 seconds remaining, I don't think they have any other chance.
Yeah, they just uber trade. 35 seconds. This is it, man. 2-3.
Yeah, this is over. Yeah, this is over. This is trash time. You have to just contest second here. And I don't think they're gonna. I think this is gonna be a red team fourth round, I think. Oh, Poki! Just gets taken
Smiley
out. Yeah, it's just 20 seconds. Yeah, it's gonna be an MGE.
Yeah,
add process second.
Very well played coming up from the Koreans. Holy crap.
I just think the Korean bomb revitalizing that fifth mid. I was actually surprised that that was actually more effective than it should supposed to be. I mean, they just bombed in and bombed out.
Huge, huge plays coming out. Hash, of course, with those crazy, crazy pipes. Got the logs up on screen right now. Top damage is going to be LK. 298 damage DPM. Pandemic not too far behind, 292. We got Harsh at 289 and Baxter at 273. So definitely the Koreans bringing the damage this time around. We got Daylight down below at 186, but he was just, you know, playing pocket and just hanging back, having fun. Ooh,
hey,
man.
I predicted this to happen.
Yeah, down to the scores. Taking a look at the medic stats though, we got 4 drops coming up from Poki. Why? Why?
I mean, I understand the process, especially when you're in the when you need to win this map, because this is I think this is their map pick. I think Poki wanted to either hold it as hard as he can, because if he forced there, that Uber would have achieved nothing. They would just kill the forcer, and I think he wanted to go for the risk play.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, but the pipe on mid was just unfortunate. Him eating that pipe from Lurl.
Yeah.
I mean, if I was playing medic, I would have been mad. I'd have been like, why am I so unlucky?
Oh, man. We will be moving on to the tiebreaker map of the night. It is going to be CP Snakewater. So it's going to be pretty interesting for this map, though. I want to see how they decide to play this through. I mean, so far, Pokey has been so reluctant to pop his Uber charges. Is that a good thing?
I mean, it's a case-by-case basis. Whenever, if he did hold that Uber and he didn't die, that would have snowballed into their last or their second. But since he always dropped, it would be a bad decision on him.
Yeah.
But either way, it's still very risky, very gambly playstyle. I think it reminds me of Harblue, but Harblue doesn't drop that much. Oof. So,
damn.
I mean, he should have popped at some cases.
Yeah.
And he shouldn't have ate that pipe from Choke. I will hammer it down. He shouldn't have ate that.
Should not be eating damage. Pro tip, don't eat damage as a medic.
I mean, it's actually quite interesting how the Koreans play this process mid, wherein they play in, like, it's like Call of Duty. They have two AC-130s, the soldiers just bombing in left and right, and it causes such a big distraction. Yeah, it's actually a big distraction for the blue team or the Prinnies to deal with it, and it's actually causing them to lose most of the fights because Stroke and LK is just walking forward, and they're just not getting any damage. They're just not getting damage there. Mm-hmm. They're not getting pressured by the demo or something, and I don't know. They need to fix. They either need to kamikaze into the Koreans.
Yeah.
Basically, just forget about your medic. Just go in for them, or play very, very, very defensively.
So what? Like, what can you do better to like deny the double Korean barbecue bombs?
I mean, the Korean double bomb is just a distraction. It's all that is. You basically watch their entire mid. They deal 100 damage, 250 damage at best. That's the best they I think I've seen from the double Korean bomb. So I think, I don't know, if they were able to clean up the soldiers very fast or either focus the scouts, I think that would be perfect for Prinnies. Especially since their scouts, Pandemic and Killer, they're both very good scouts. So, yeah.
Yep, so just waiting on them to get in the server. I think they'll, like, everyone's just having a look at the logs right now. Everyone's stacking blue, apparently. But we're just gonna have to wait and see once everyone gets in. Yeah, for those of you who are just only joining us, a very good evening and welcome to the AsiaFortress Cup Season 13! It is the Div 1 Upper Bracket Semi-Finals. We've got the Prinny Pirate Plunderers facing off against Eat Sleep Game. Each team took a map each, 3-2 on Cough Product and 2-3 on CP Process. Really close games. Really exciting games, so I'm really curious to see how the teams play on the tiebreaker map, which is of course going to be CP Snakewater. So this is to determine who gets pushed down into the lower bracket to face off against, who are they facing off against? I think Supnu, yeah, they should be facing off against Supnu Puas. And then the one in the upper bracket will be facing off against, I don't know how to pronounce that team name because it's just a smiley face, let's just call them Xiao because that's technically who they are. And yeah, so that is going to be what's going to be going down once everyone readies up, I guess. Everyone's just stacking blue because who doesn't like that color after all, Strelka and Harsh. Yeah, there they go, they're just swapping back to their respective colors right now.
It's actually quite interesting that you see what Killed did. I think Prinnies understand that the double Korean bomb is causing such a great distraction that Killed actually pulled out the shotgun and just yeah. Auto shotgun denied their soldiers. Yep. I think he wants to be a third scout and then an AC-130 after the mid. So I think they recognize that. I think they're gonna focus on the soldiers, I think. So this might end well for Prinnies because they have more experience, I believe. Mm-hmm. Especially they have more adaptive capability. So I think this is gonna be a 5-3.
Gonna take this map 5-3.
Yes.
Ooh. Interesting. Can't wait to see what teams, how it plays out later on. Just waiting for everyone to ready up. We've got a couple of AFKs. Everyone needs to go for that, the toilet break, get some drinks, make sure that they're well hydrated, make sure they're all ready for this final round, this tiebreaker map, CP Snakewater. And we're just gonna have to see who comes out on top, who grabs this game.
So here's what I'm expecting from the Korean bomb. The Korean bomb basically just going to be walking into the enemy kitchen and then causing a chaos in kitchen as well. And then jumping into the combo, and then the Stroka and the LK scout combo would just walk in and kill the entire team. I think that's what's going to happen in the first mid. Basically their soldiers just ran like, diversionary tactics. That's the most apt way to put it.
We just go way deep in. We've got the votes coming in. Everyone's casting their votes to see who they think is going to take this map. ESG is currently getting 59% of the votes, with the Prinny's getting only 41. This is going to be pretty interesting. ESG seems to be the crowd favorite at the moment, though. We're just going to have to see how things play out as things go along. Just waiting on Strelka as well as Killer to ready up. Just waiting on Strelka to ready up. And then we can actually see how they perform.
Alright, starting.
2, 1. Right, going to be going live after a couple of restarts. Once again, those of you who are just popping in, welcome to the Age of Fortress Cup Season 13. This is the Div 1 Upper Bracket Semi-Finals. We've got the Prinny Pirate Plunderers on the blue team, as well as Eat Sleep Game on the red team. So far, each team has taken a map each, and this is going to be the tiebreaker map of the night to see who stays in that upper bracket. Gonna follow Lurl for his rollout this time around, see how he makes his way to mid, and see if we get that double solid Korean bomb again.
I think it's gonna be a double soldier Korean stealth bomb.
Stealth bombs coming in.
Yeah, I think you're gonna see it here.
You're already gonna see Daylight up top, Baxter up top as well. Daylight going straight deep down, trying to find that medic.
Spots
him up on the catwalk, unable to land those shots. He's gonna go down. Baxter tries to do the exact same thing. Not enough EV, just gets a little bit of fall damage. And they're just losing.
The Prinnies are actually very smart.
Oh yeah, Killer, Killer, and the Scouts, Pandemic, they're just chasing them all the way. LK's coming in from behind though! Maybe...
That was so smart!
LK maybe might have went for the medic instead. Instead he just went for the Soli and just get absolutely destroyed.
Oh, but it seems like... Yeah, that was actually very smart by the Prinnies. They actually positioned their medic into catwalk.
Yeah.
Because they already know that the Korean bomb is going to be coming.
Gonna have those offcasters coming out. No offcasters. Right, that's because the ESG players, they aren't gonna have that Uber charge ready to contest this last line push. Daylight gonna be watching the flanks. Kill gonna be on the left side, watching that the main choke area. Smiley just zero respect, jumping in, tries to find the medic but loses him, spots him again, tries to get the force, the medic is gonna be alone.
Oh my god!
Baxter comes in to save his life.
He just refuses to pop. He's so stubborn.
LK's on sniper. Trying to see if
it's actually helping his team better. Yeah, this is gonna be a classic stalemate here.
Yeah.
Especially with a 1-1 map.
Mm-hmm.
Map score. I don't think both teams are very I think both teams are very reluctant to hold to push out here. Especially or sending a sack.
Yeah, gets a good headshot down.
Oh wait, never mind. Smiley's gonna go in again.
Smiley. Oh, once again. Just Pokey, 85 health, holding on to the Doobie Charge. Smiley tried his best.
It would actually be interesting if they send out the scout instead.
They're trying to be peeking from lower. Pandemic just wanting to walk straight in. Killer just backing out.
Wait, the red team, the Koreans didn't want to have a sniper. Okay, now they're switching off the sniper again. Oh, the Stroker gets taken down though, so I think LK is gonna switch off the scout. Yeah. Especially since he's not gonna switch off, so
they've got the
lobby. Left side is very weak here.
Smiley getting headshot twice!
Jesus Christ! That's a frag movie clip right now.
Just plucking Smiley out of the air, clipping his wings, not letting him do anything. Huge picks, holy crap, and once again, another stalemate. Everyone's just gonna reset once again, wait for Smiley to reach the front lines to see if he can get a pick. And,
it will come to a point where Smiley keeps failing his bombs, and then Killed will get frustrated and he will bomb himself. Actually, no, Pandemic's on sniper, never mind. I thought that would be happening, especially on the process game before. So, I don't think that's gonna happen soon.
Okay, trying to pick on through the lobby, but he's just getting spammed out. Pandemic got it right there, yeah. Doesn't spot his head though. Ooh, Pandemic waiting for LK to pick.
Wait, Strelka's spy!
Strelka's spy?
No, he's just checking for off passes, yeah. He knows that Pandemic's on sniper, so I think they're gonna be more wary of that.
Mm-hmm. Pandemic trying to inch as much as he can through that corridor. LK.
I mean, both teams are reluctant to take space.
Yeah.
I mean, if they're this reluctant, they could just sack in infinitely, ruin Smiley's stats with 50-100 deaths. I mean, that could happen. but I don't think Smiley wants to do that.
Pandemic tries to go for a shot, but doesn't quite land it. And they're just gonna start backing up once again. LK is just watching that lobby. Making sure nothing peeks through there. Daylight's gonna be watching lower. They're backing up pretty far though for the side of the Prinnies.
Oh, it seems like the Prinnies are trying to take space on lobby here, trying to... Oh, they're not gonna push your sniper in? No, it seems like they're gonna bait them to the sniper side line. But the medic already is on shed here, so I don't think they're gonna be able to peek here. The sniper's just walking forward. This
Oh no,
he might get caught here. That's some good cover by Lurl, sticking up their sniper so he doesn't get caught there.
Smiley trying to peek from lower. No one's spamming him out yet. Finally, the Soli does come rotate back around. Just a bit of a stalematey stalemate right now, Smiley. Getting in for free! Oh, nope, backing out.
Oh, he gets a headshot! LK is very low right now, so he might back off. Yeah, he gets arrowed, so it doesn't matter. Yeah,
Pandemic's
gonna peek again here.
Spots the medic, tries to get shots, but he's gonna get punished and destroyed. And Pokey's still fine, still up and well. Low.
Yeah, I believe that Killed got frustrated there.
Oh,
he gets
Pandemic!
Okay. Some good shot. Yeah, Killed got frustrated there. It's time for me to bomb. It's time for me to ruin my stats. Yeah, I think they're gonna push. Oh, what? Pandemic gets taken out by another sniper. He did not expect that. He thought there would be only one sniper. Oh, Lur's gonna get caught here, I think, in lower. Oh, he doesn't get caught, so that's very good for blue team. They're gonna be able to hold blue. I mean, the second.
Strucker potentially pushing up through lower. They do re-grab this lobby area, so it's a little bit more breathing for them. Baxter's gonna get full buffed, trying to check for stickies and spots the medic. Maybe go for a jump, maybe not.
Oh yeah, that's some good damage here. Actually, Strucker's gonna go lower. Yeah, he gets caught. Oh my god, Smiley's beefing his shots! Oh no! Misses four rockets, gets out DM'd by Stroka.
Oh,
this is what happens when there's no add snake water second.
Yeah. Killed is running the battalions back up again.
Oh no! This is the reason why they lost in the Div 2 Grand
in.
Finals.
He's going in.
Why?
What's the medic? Pokey
has
to pop it!
Limited.
Oh, Pokey doesn't pop.
Care.
His second rocket doesn't
care.
Get anything at all.
I mean, I don't understand. Why would he sack in with the battalion's backup for only 30 HP? I think that was what he was going for. He wanted that 30 HP free buff, but I would have preferred the shotgun. But that's the reason why I'm not Div 1. So
once again, both teams just waiting for mistakes.
Killed on heavy.
Oh no!
I'm very proud. I'm super proud. What is this? He's just walking there. He doesn't even have the eviction notice. Not optimized for competitive play. Very lazy, heavy man.
Is peeking lobby.
What is
he
planning
shot
on
down,
this?
Though. He does get.
Oh no!
Oh, there you are. That's killer down.
I mean, it still doesn't matter. Like blue team has a heavy. I don't think they can sack in, but they can push in their sniper here because they have a heavy. Yeah, it seems like Pandemic's gonna get spammed out in lobby. The sniper's peeking low lobby here. He's gonna try and peek the. Oh, he sees. Oh, never mind. Lurl takes out LK, and then the heavy, 1v1 in the sniper. This isn't real life. Bullets don't deal 190 damage.
Stroka still trying to get those sight lines down. Spots the rocket launcher. He spots the heavy. Gets a body shot, not enough to kill him.
I still don't understand this heavy play though. Like, they should be using this health to achieve something. Yeah, Pandemic goes to die there on the right side. So it might signal. Oh, never mind. He gets spammed out by Smiley. Some good damage on the lobby side area.
If he just spamming
like
that, they may all get
caught
out.
Pop it.
Or Uber's gonna get popped. They're gonna drop that demo weapon.
This is gonna be bad.
Oh, they got a terrible Uber charge. But
Smiley's gonna go for
a
force. Oh, yes, the force is in. This might actually be a
Smiley's
good hold for
the point. Gonna get denied.
Yeah, this might be a good this might be a good hold for blue team here, especially with that heavy weapons guy.
Yeah. There's no way they can push out from that. Daylight's gonna be at 79. The medic EV just walks into that rocket! Not enough to pick him up though, LK is just walking
14
out.
14 HP gets taken out by LK! Oh, I think blue team is gonna go for the backup. I think they're gonna go for it. I think they have to go for it. They're
Killed
actually
and the demo are just walking out. LK has to defend this against that demo man. And the heavy weapons
he
guy 20 health, he's down. Scout's on the point. Soli's up there, they have to stop it!
Wow. The heavy actually worked.
The heavy actually worked!
Alright, this is why the heavy meta is very important in 6's Asian. But that should have worked though. I mean, if Pokey only didn't pop immediately just because of Smiley pushing onto him.
Speaking of Smiley, going inside kitchen behind everyone, spots the medic, no one knows he's there, he's gonna jump the medic straight down, the scout finally does spot him and does punish him for trying to do anything. The medic does spot the other Soli as well, who's currently behind them, watching his flanks, 52 health, jumping straight down.
Oh, the medic's getting caught out here! 40 HP, he does survive, this is actually very good for blue here. Actually, no, never mind, this is a red team's mid to take, but red team has three down! What? Kill just takes down two players! He's just on a rampage
going
here.
Back in, they want blood. Trying to get that medic.
Blair's gonna go for the aggressive bomb. It seems like Kilt is gonna go hunting for the medic here, I think. No?
Nope.
He's not. He's gonna be satisfied with this. Yeah, I think they're gonna be satisfied with this one point. Oh, Leo might get caught out here.
Capturing this midpoint. Smiley's
gonna go in!
Oh no. Oh.
Where's that 100% success rate, Force? Oh, Eevee might get caught out here. Okay, that's good. What? They're gonna push this? They might have dropped the scout. Yeah, they did drop the scout. This is actually very bad. They shouldn't play forward here. They need to get forced. The red team needs to get forced here before they can use Ubers if they want to hold this midfight. Yes, they're wanting to hold this midfight. Actually, Kilt is gonna try and go for the trade here. The Uber's been popped for the blue team. Yeah, the retrade.
They just
gonna
use it to back out, yeah.
What? Eevee's caught! Oh no, he surfs! He surfs the rocket into safety. That's some great play by Eevee.
Daylight's in.
But Eevee doesn't know where to go!
Oh, there you go. Daylight comes in, picks up Smiley and Eevee. This should be the point going... Wait, what?
What?! Oh my god! Killer! Killer just takes out the scout and the medic. Is he gonna get more? Is he gonna get this demo
He's
man?
Gonna get
Is
the demo man?
Oh my god, what a miracle player.
3k for Killer. He's gonna be standing on his second point.
There is no way, they should have won that!
Wow.
I mean, they were all bunched up on kitchen, but still. So it's gonna be another stalemate, I believe?
Oh, please.
Actually,
huh?
No, I think...
They've
yeah, I think
they
have
a slight Uber ad, so they should push in the moment they have it.
Yeah, they're building hard here. Actually, nah, they're not building. Oh, I think they believe that they have Uber, they have equal Uber, so
but
this might not be the push.
The medic, though. And then, yeah, Pokey's gonna try his very best to grind it out. They're just gonna have like maybe 20% ad, and that's about it, so 10-20.
Yeah.
So, yeah, they're not gonna do anything with this.
I mean, 20% ad, that's
and,
pretty hard.
But it looks
to
like they
wanna
do something with it,
what?
Though. They're going in,
this
they're
is
going
a
in.
Botch push.
Sentry gun's gonna be right there, they pop their new charge, sentry gun's down. And much
red team is
on the side of ESG, they pop it as well. And they're gonna start potentially playing around the point.
Oh,
it's right there!
What? They lost? Oh no, what? What happened?
They were not looking out for the scouts. They were so preoccupied with pushing them back and the two scouts just rushed the point. Oh, jeez.
Damn, that was so unfortunate because Killed got air headshot. And that was a sick shot. Seems like Smiley's hiding in kitchen again. I think he's gonna go for a bomb right now. Nope, he's just baiting there. The soldier's taking the high ground from the for the Koreans here. Oh, Smiley gets taken out in kitchen there. So the scouts from the red side, they're gonna push towards mid, and the soldier going to. Okay, they're taking the high ground from blue team, and it seems like they're playing back here. Yep, that was a very clean fight.
I can't seem to tab back into TF2, what? What?
Alright, so I'll take over for a bit, so it's
Yeah, just keep narrating. Because I can't control the camera at all.
They're gonna try and push into choke here. They're spamming them out really hard, some good damage from okay, actually never mind. Dayla's gonna try and bomb into the enemy medic, but the enemy Eevee does not force there. So it's gonna be one down for the red team. They're all bunched up on choke here, so if someone goes from Blow or Smiley, possibly, or even Catwalk, they could even go for the force. So, actually, some good damage from the choke side area. I don't think Smiley wants to force here. Yep, they're just sitting up on choke. I think they're content with holding this with the 2-up, the 2-0 scoreline that they lead. Actually, Smiley going for the force here. I don't understand. He went in for the soldier instead, so 300 HP soldier versus 300 HP soldier. Both of them survived there in choke. Yeah, so this is going to be another stalemate.
I'm going to take this time to relaunch TF2, so apologies for the black screen.
Oh, it's paused?
Keep talking.
Oh no! The server is lagging! Everyone's 200 ping, I think. Oh no, it's Lurl's ping. Lurl's ping is 200, so I don't think... Yeah, the pause is in right now, so it's just gonna be another stalemate.
There's a pause?
Yeah.
Perfect timing, we can relaunch TF2.
Yeah, he timed out here, so they're gonna be a demo down. So I think red team, especially with that 15-minute timer, 15 minutes and 39 seconds to be more specific, they need to sack in a player or sack in a player or push in. I mean, my bad.
Yep.
People are asking me what happened to you.
Yeah, I don't know. TF2 just decided not to work. Everything was still running fine, but I just couldn't click. And I still can't click? What? I can launch TF2, but I can't even click anything.
Oh,
this has never happened before. What the fuck?
Oh, no.
Oh, no.
It's still paused. I'm going to ask them if they're going to wait for you.
I really don't know why I can't even control TF2. I can launch it, but I can't even play it.
Pandemic's asking me, what should we do? I mean, I think Lurl still hasn't connected. Yeah, I think they're waiting for you.
I can't even control TF2. What's going on? I don't understand.
Wait, streamer down. He said we'll wait.
So sweet of him.
Pandemic said we'll win. I mean, this is going to be a 2-0 lead still for TCF. Wait, what? No! Oof. Wrong team! Oops! I was talking about Pretty Pirate. Oh my god, PPP! Jesus Christ, I'm getting confused already. I'm getting messaged left and right if what happened to you. I mean, I think you're getting DDoSed.
I don't know, does DDoS affect TF2?
Maybe it's another program.
Yeah, I can launch TF2 fine, but I can't even click anything.
Yeah, Lurl's already connecting here, so... Yeah, I think they're gonna wait for you. That's the definite thing here. Oh no. Lurl's already on spectator.
Okay, people are telling me to close my Discord? Alright, let's give that a shot. Right! It looks like I have everything back in order. Are you there, ifun? No, it looks like Discord has hung. Wow. Why is Discord screwing me over?
Hello, I am here. Nice. I am back. So, it's a 2-1 scoreline for the red team. I mean...
Okay.
I mean, the red team did push out because of Lurl dying there, or timed out. So they're now pushing onto the enemy second, or the Koreans are just defending second. Well, actually, no, Pandemic takes down Pokey, so that's Uber add into EV here. A little bit of Brick. Oh, actually, Lurl with that big pipe onto Baxter. But Stroka gets the revenge kill on Eevee. That's some good play by Stroka, equalizing that Uber ad. And Killer wanting that blood, going for daylight right now. So can you see the stream now? I mean, can you see the game?
It's all good.
Control TF2. Yeah. So that's all you missed. All
right.
I tried to chat cast. That's the best I could do. They already know it's a 2-1, so it's all good.
It's all good. Yeah, apologies to everyone for that downtime, it appears. Yeah, Discord did screw me over. It was the overlay, apparently, even though I've never seen it before. But here we are. Everyone's gonna be contesting this second point. The medic may get caught out, Pokey! Gonna get poked with the rockets coming out from Smiley, and we go Baxter tries to pick up the medic! And EV is gonna go down to Strelka, just helping out his Soli friends.
Bombing in. This is just a full-on DM fight. Oh, what? Pandemic's going behind! Last. He can't go for it.
They stopped the cap? Oh, there you go.
There's no way. He has to go for the medic. He's gonna go for back.
Soli's
okay.
Spotting.
Oh, what?
Goes for the medic.
Okay, he's shooting out. Oh, he almost gets the medic. That was actually... It almost gave me a heart attack there. I thought he would be able to get the medic with that low HP with 72 HP. I don't think that would be possible.
Smiley jumping but forward. Just linking up with his team. They've only got the demo in the
Yeah, with blue team scout. Yeah. Yeah, with blue team scout dead right now, there's no area denial
for the
blue
double
team,
bombs.
So this might be very bad. Yeah, Smiley gets taken out and killed. Oh, the double bomb coming in, saving! Oh, the Korean Predator missile reigns supreme. Now that the AC-130s for the blue team are gone, it's now the scout, the infantry bed coming into the choke side air. What? The artillery from Lurl coming? What is this, a war game?
Harsh!
Oh, never mind, Harsh. Jesus Christ, what is happening?
What? Okay!
The infant. Oh no, don't die either!
Stroka! What are they doing? Why are they just sending people in desperately trying to get the ping down onto the medic? They just so desperately want to just equalize the supercharge. Pokey just spawning in.
That was some good bombs, but still, I don't understand what was happening. Has science gone too far?
Smiley's on the medic again.
Oh, Smiley! Let's get taken out. So I think red team is gonna go aggress here. They're gonna go for the midpoint. Yep. And they pop. Eevee. Oh, Lurl gets Stroka in daylight. The one pipe, two kills. I think I've seen that before. So yeah, they're gonna push Lowy here with the three down, killed, jumping onto that log area. Gonna try and spam out the demo man. I think. Yep. He's just gonna maintain ground here. Yeah, I believe they're gonna be satisfied with this 1 scoreline advantage.
Yeah, it's up on the Koreans actually to do something about
Pokey, this. Pokey has Uber here, so they're gonna push here. Hopefully they don't get back capped.
Smiley just hanging up on that pike. Spots everyone. Oh, gonna take down the demo man. Oh dear me.
He's the red team is actually very Oh no! No way! Pokey eats a pipe and then eats the roller! That's so unfortunate! The moment he jumped out of ramp, he just eats a pipe and then the roller from the platform.
Stroke's in on the medic.
Destroyed him!
Oh, the Soli bomb. Oh!
Daylight!
Ooh! Crispy.
I don't understand. That was such a derpy death. Yeah, they need to back out here. This is just a. Wait, no. It seems like the scout for the blue team is gonna go for the backup? Yeah, it seems like he's gonna go for the back cap, and the blue team is trying desperately to stop second. They need to stop it right now. If they wanna succeed, Killed is
health.
On the point. Oh my
How
god!
How is he still alive?
Lurl is just pounding! Someone make the Skadoosh meme right now. It's gonna make Lurl happy.
Pokey's down again. No heals on last. Stickies are already in play on that point. That Soli is so low, he's potentially gone, but Scott does come in to save his life.
Oh no, Eevee! Oh, Eevee just scares out the scout, goes for the arrow. Eevee's gonna go for the point!
No.
Oh no. Yeah, they're just wiping. I don't understand. I think they've lost their entire momentum because of...
Pandemic potentially going last? Trying to see if he can get that sneak
back. Yeah.
Spot
yeah,
by
I feel
LK,
like.
Yeah.
Oh no. He's gonna get caught. Their entire. Both of their scouts just go for the back cap. Why? Okay, it seems like the soldiers are gonna be up again. It's the AC-130s for the blue side. Oh, yeah. So the infantrymen are currently down. The push is gonna go from lower from the Korean side. So good damage from Kill.
Smiley's in again on Pokey!
Oh! Wall shot! Amazing shot by Smiley. Does take down Pokey. This is gonna be a blue mid. Hopefully a second mid. Baxter's gonna go for the big play onto the medic. He jumps in. He doesn't see the medic initially, oh, but that's good enough because he is informing that the demo man does feed. Never mind. I thought he would be able to get the medic. So this is gonna
full
be
wipe for ESG. And Lil still.
This gonna be a
huge.
3-1.
This may very well be a 3-1. Lil already gonna start moving forward. We don't have any off-classing yet though for the side of the Koreans. It may be high time. There you go. Strucker's gonna be on that sniper roll. We're watching that lobby side. They're gonna grind out that Uber Charge. They're gonna have it really soon, and they're probably just gonna push in the moment they have it because that is what they need to do to push this up to 3-1.
Darl's actually doing so much for his team right now.
Oh,
he's
yeah,
pulling them out of the cusp of death.
Right side.
So Kill just gonna beef his rocket jump. Oh my god, Kill, stop beefing your rocket jump, friend. He just walked into the left side, doesn't even think. Oh no.
Smiley's
this might actually be a red
again.
Oh, it's a 4-1. Oh my god, even that botched rocket jumps from Kill, he still was able to deal enough damage for the entirety of his team to push into the last and get that 3-1. Hopefully it's a 5-2 like I predicted.
still time on the clock for a comeback game for the Koreans. We're gonna see a mid-fight underway once again. Smiley getting that high ground, getting ready to start bombing, waiting for another arrow potentially. Nope, doesn't need that arrow anyways.
Oh my god, the AC-130 is coming in!
He's gonna get bounced all the way back. Nice
arrow! Oh, he gets
eliminated! Bax is gonna get 23 health. Don't think he can do anything right there. EV's still in the healthy range, as is Pokey, and everyone's just hanging back on their side. Demo Man,
oh,
they get caught out daylight!
Up. Get
oh,
sent in the air!
Dalkaze doesn't want up. Can he defend his medic? He's...
Yeah, it seems like he's rushing into Saw area. He's gonna get caught
yeah,
here!
Go.
Yep. This is gonna be a 4-1, hopefully, unless EV dies again from the soldier. Which, I'm pretty sure he should not be able to be killed here,
yeah,
because his team is very wary. They already know. They have the experience to understand that their medic is gonna get sacked here. Or either they're gonna run engineer and sniper on last. Yep, that's what's gonna happen.
Mm-hmm.
So they're just gonna hold their left side spawn here.
Oh, doesn't quite
oh,
clip the medic. Ooh, that's a shame.
Oh, but they're getting robbed. Uber is essentially useless.
Oh, the stickies,
right now.
Bro.
Oh no! What?
What?
Oh my god, he hits a penetration shot from his teammate. How is that even allowed? I would be pretty mad.
Pandemic is behind, he might go for the sticky back cap.
Wait,
oh,
is
the two scouts,
allowed?
The two scouts are right there!
But oh, they're not stopping second!
14 health, yeah, not enough. Corp scouts are dead. Try to go for the sneaky plays, just not
is
enough.
Is the Machina not allowed?
I
thought it was
think,
bad.
Yeah. But teams have been using it throughout the entire season.
Oh, soldiers jumping in for the medic! Oh my god, he just destroys Pokey, eliminates him off the match.
Just
that was some good
Smiley play. Again, they need to do something about Smiley. They have to deny that jump
oh, no,
constantly.
It seems like a. Yeah.
Scouts in.
That's gonna be over.
Okay, picks up the Solly, but he's not gonna be able to pick up anything else. EV's still alive, 141
yeah,
health
regen. Catwalk area here. The props are coming in.
Demo's
oh,
in.
The soldier going behind! There's stickies though.
Oh, struggles
so
in.
He's gonna be in Catwalk. EV might get screwed here. Oh no, the bomb is in, but the anti-air combat from the infantryman, that was some good play, now it's time for the
Strelka,
artillery!
Strelka in the strays
oh,
and the jumps, the Solly is right there to
oh,
back him
no,
up. Strelka has to land his shots though. Solly Baxter is still alive, Strelka dies to a long-range rocket. And midpoint, still in the hands of ESG. 4 minutes 49 seconds counting down. And oh, pause.
Oh no, it's another pause.
Is it another ping issue?
What? It kills AFK! AFK in the semifinals? Why? I don't understand.
Oh jeez. But they have to do something about Smiley. That I don't know how many times Smiley has picked off Pokey constantly, even dropping him, like just negating any push potential that ESG have. And like Eevee's holding onto that full overcharge, so they really have no fear contesting the second point. With 4
yeah,
minutes
I mean,
and 45 seconds left on the clock, it's really up to ESG to do something about this.
I mean, the problem is, right, like, the red team pushes in very methodically, and it's very predictable that the medic is going to come out at a certain time. So what they need to do is be more careful. Of course, they already know that, but they need to delay their medic as well, because especially when you're playing Call of Duty, when there's a predator missile going for you, you hide with a place with a roof.
Yep.
So, yeah, he just needed to stay there in the choke side area, in the saw area, so he doesn't get bombed instantly, or he doesn't get forced or killed. So I think they could have worked that out better.
That's right, gotta watch the skies. We got some funny information inside Twitch chat right now. We have people telling us that Killed is not even online anymore. Some people saying that he's 2 hours past his bedtime and that his parents cut his internet at 12! Mom! Play video games! Oh my gosh, this is hilarious. So we're just gonna have to wait and see what's gonna happen.
Jesus Christ, the AC 130.
Yeah, Kill just messaged low. It's doing the retarded configuring Windows update thing. Yeah, so Windows update kind of screwed him over.
I mean, since it's 4 minutes already, I think Red Team is going to be hard-pressed. So yeah. The Korean double bomb will convert from stealth mode to AC 130 mode. They're going to go in hot in the next mid, I hope. I mean, that's what I'm hoping, because there's already 4 minutes left. And if they were able to push last, which I highly doubt they would be able to, they only have 2 minutes or 3 minutes at best. And I don't think it's still possible for them to cap all second. I mean, 2 points.
Yeah.
So I think it's over already.
Yeah,
but
there's
of
like,
course.
2 minutes yeah, it's to still... get like a point each. That's really tough based on how they're playing as well, with Smiley constantly picking up Pokey. It's going to be really tough. It's not impossible, but they really have to step their game up if they want to bring this into a golden cap.
Yeah, I want to see that Korean aggression again, like in that process where they were able to just rescue that fight. They were actually they were able to rescue that map with just sheer Korean bombingness. Just the soldiers just creating so much distraction that the scouts just walk in, just like good damage on the scouts. So I hope that happens as well. So I don't know.
Yeah, hopefully we get to see some more bombs coming up from Baxter and Daylight. They've been doing a massive job, of course, but just not enough. Just not enough. With Smiley just jumping in, just getting free reign, apparently. The scouts nowhere to be seen. Sometimes they do successfully deny Smiley, but other times Smiley just sneaks on through. So it's just, I don't know, Smiley seems to be the one making all the plays for them on Snakewater. So
oh, yeah, I definitely agree.
Yeah. So, but for the side of the Koreans, though, do they have their own playmaker?
I mean, we're not seeing exactly the effects of the Korean playmakers, like Stroka and LK, not exactly doing as much as the Smiley and Lirl combo. Yeah. I mean, up to this late point of the game, you've seen Lirl drop the medic from across the map with a spam pipe.
Yeah.
And then Smiley just constantly equalizing that Uber ad. Other than that, Red Team is kind of mellow right now. I think they could be able to be more aggressive, so they would be able to make those plays, because they're definitely capable of it.
So just gonna have to wait and see once Kilt comes back. Oof. I mean, just... they've got the full Uber charge. Pokey's at 30%. They're definitely not gonna be able to push into the second point, unless they can somehow get a play. It's going to be really tight for them. And, you know, with like 4 minutes and 45 seconds counting down, they need to do something. They need to just go all out. Double solid bomb.
Yeah, I think it's either they play back, but knowing the Koreans, they're going to play super passive. And, of course, this is going to be lying in favor of the Prinnies. I think a risky play, a Blitzkrieg into the enemy second would be pretty okay. It's still pretty risky, but they're 3-1 right now.
Yep.
So it's up to them.
Do we have any update on Killed's current situation? I saw him inside Twitch chat like a few minutes ago. He was like, give me 5 minutes. Oh Jeez, man.
I mean, at least the red team or the Koreans use 3 pauses in that viaduct product game.
Just pause, go, go.
I'm actually gonna search it up if Machina is allowed. I'm actually confused. I thought it was banned.
Yeah. So, but like, I don't know. Maybe the whitelist hasn't been updated. I don't know. I know Karl Mangler's banned. That's why no one's using it right now. But as for the Machina, not too sure anymore.
I mean, that's still a pretty good. That's still a pretty game changer. I mean, if he doesn't, if he wasn't using the Machina, he would have killed the Smiley here. So. I don't know.
Yeah, it gives away a position immediately as well, but that penetration damage, man. Ouchies. Ooh, so yeah, just waiting for Kilt to come back online to get plugged in and whatnot. For those of you who are just joining us, very good evening. Welcome to the AsiaFortress Cup Season 13. We are currently on an upper bracket semi-finals for the Div 1 bracket. It is the Prinny Pirate Plunderers facing off against Eat Sleep Game. And we are currently on the tiebreaker map with the Prinnies currently 2 points up, 3-1 in favor of the Prinnies, of course. ESG trying to gain their footing, trying to see if they can bring this into a golden cap or do something at all, because so far they've been just getting pounded by Smiley, who's been constantly bombing the heck out of Pokey.
I would like to bring out bad news. Yep. I just checked.
It's banned?
Machina is banned. I don't know if this is the correct link, but I'm looking at it right now. I clicked the Asia Fortress Cup 13 unlocks link from Fushi, and I clicked the 6v6 global whitelist, and I control F Machina, and it seems like it's banned.
Oh, dear me. Teams have been using it throughout the season, though. Are we going to disqualify everyone?
I mean, it doesn't matter. Blue team has still won, so...
Yeah.
I mean, it's up to the admins at this point.
If things line up and you get, like, a massive play, then I guess, you know, that is just, you know, bad. Because it wouldn't have happened if it wasn't a Machina. So, like, technically Smiley shouldn't have died. But... Or whoever that was that died. But... I don't know, whitelist not updated. I'm sure there are admins inside Twitch chat right now, so...
Whitelist isn't updated, admins. Something needs to be done.
I mean, they've been breaking rules since the beginning, though.
Since the dawn of time.
Because if I recall, you're only allowed one pause per map. I think that's... I think that was section 4E? I'm not very familiar with the rules, but I think that's 4E. I'm not very sure. But I believe that you can only pause for one map and then the Koreans pause
like
only for 3.
Pauses per map and stuff.
But, yeah, Kill just launched the game.
That's good, that's good. Can get this game back on the road. 4 minutes and 45 left on the server clock. So I really want to see what the Koreans can do with this. Hopefully they do something. I want to see them, you know, try to push this to golden cap. We always like to see golden caps, it's always exciting. Unless it's a full-on 45-minute stalemate game, then that's going to be really boring. But we're just going to have to wait and see once Kilt comes back in. So Kilt will not be at the front lines, but they are just holding second, so it shouldn't be that bad when he walks back. But I don't think it's going to spark a push from the Koreans, because you know, Eevee's holding on to the full overcharge. They can pretty much just park the bus on the second point. And, you know... But, yeah, we're just going to have to wait and see what they do.
Wait, actually, this might cause them to push on red team. Because since Lurl and Kild basically are dead, since Kild just disconnected, this might be the push or a sack from red team.
Yeah. So Lurl's only going to be spawning in 2 seconds. Probably going to be at the same time as Kild. So they are Strelka down, 9 second respawn time, but they don't have the Ruby charge. So they may send like Baxter or Daylight in to try to get the force. Baxter's already at like 262 health, already buffed up. So just going to have to wait and see what they decide to do. Definitely they're just going through what their plans are right now, as we are going through, thinking what they're thinking. We're just going to have to wait and see once the unpause goes down. Is Killed in yet? I don't think so. Because they got to unpause it before Iken comes in, so...
Yeah.
Just going to have to wait and see.
So hopefully red team needs to aggress here, especially with that 4 minute up.
Yeah. There you go.
Alright, it's unpausing.
Yep, unpause. Everyone's
yep,
regrouped.
They're two down.
Oh, Smiley just zero respect. All
oh, they're gonna push
in? Yeah, they're walking straight
he
in.
He backs out.
Pandemic's gonna be shiny.
Oh, what?
He's gonna get the horse.
Oh, that Daylight Forces! That's some good play.
I think that was their intention to begin with, but they are gonna lose both their Solis. Pandemic is just watching that window, and the Koreans are already just getting pushed to last. So, Kill's gonna get the point first.
Smiley's gonna get oh, he gets levitated.
Denied.
So, trying to fight those combo players on the lower side does not work. Actually, he's gonna try and aggress here with no buff, no fear. He's actually 3v1ing right now, and there's a soldier in cheese. Oh,
Kill.
Hits a rocket onto the medic. Oh, Stroka gets flown into the air. Yeah, that's some good play here. They were able to hold second, and they're gonna push mid here. Hopefully, they get the medic and then
yeah.
snowball all through last.
They need
that is their
to
only
get
chance
medic
here.
Pick. But the
yeah,
medic's
they're
already
go
way
here.
Out of choke at the
yeah, I don't think they're gonna force here. Oh, actually, Smiley's going in. Yep, they're not. They waited for Smiley. They literally waited on Kitchen. That's.
They knew. They knew actually, he was coming. But Eevee's gonna have his image charge really soon, so I don't think, you know, they need to do something.
Yeah, they need to fasten up. They need to quick enough. Yeah, the Uber's been popped. They need to go for the mech. Oh, never
yep,
mind.
Uber trade.
The medic does have his Uber. Actually, Daylight's
oh,
gonna
no.
get caught.
Poke
here.
Is getting
yep.
juggled.
Oh, but oh. the demo goes down for blue team with two down. Oh, actually, the
Backstage
red team is just
them.
Pushing.
Backstage
oh my
the medic.
God.
Oh, bumps into Smiley.
This might end very badly for blue here if their medic gets caught. Never mind, they're not gonna get their medic caught here. Actually, a scout 1v1 pandemic versus LK. The entirety of red team trying to support him there. Yep, that's good. That's three down. They need to. Oh, actually, the spawn just came up, so I think they're not gonna push here. They're gonna play for Uber, I believe, and then they're gonna push.
Yep, because they're already at that 75%. And for the side of the Prinnies, they already got the heavy up as well, so that is something that they have to worry about. Got that sandwich and the brass beast! Gonna get that damage reduction. It looks like they're gonna push from the left side flank from the defender's perspective. Getting all those buffs. We already got the Soli jumping up top. Smiley gonna be right there. Uber gonna get popped straight away onto that Scout Stroker. Gonna focus down that Demo Man. Heavy made short work of standing on the point. Soli has absolutely nothing done at all.
Oh,
Demo
no.
Man's gonna be right there. He does get that plus 25! Uber saw down, popped that Uber charge. Smiley is gonna be saved.
Is
LK still alive. Sticky play, sticky.
The Demo needs a dead!
Oh, the
is
medic
this enough?
Right there, the medic with the Ubisoft!
It's not enough!
25. Scar's gonna be right there!
Enough.
What?!
Eevee just saved that last for them! He just saved- He might have actually saved the map! Actually, Baxter going for that last point, but still Eevee getting that plus 25 and then getting the medic at the end.
Eevee got that Ubisoft charge just in time. And this
now, blue
is-
Blue team is just gonna-
Yeah, this is
yeah.
pushing them into trash time. At most, they can grab 3-2, but- This is it, man. Holy crap, Eevee, that play.
I predicted that. I actually mispronounced 5-2 into 3-1.
So
just
jumping
in
getting
back
juggled,
there.
Standing on the point.
What the
they
hell?
Grab it.
What the hell? This might actually still be possible. If the Korean bomb has been revitalized.
A minute and 20 seconds to push coast to coast.
25 kill streak detected. Tactical nuke incoming. Here comes the Korean bomb. I believe we're gonna go to Golden Cap. I hope.
Maybe possible. I hope so. Solis are gonna be up top. Daylight.
Need to go in.
Get ready for that bomb. Kill can be up top already. Coming straight now. Spot the medic EV! May get caught out. He's circled out from his team. He can't heal them at the front lines. He's
oh,
just gonna
no.
go through cleanup, but they do lose Pokey. They
it's
lose
over.
Ash. They lose absolutely everybody. The only person that's gonna be struck, not anymore. Full wipe on this midpoint fight, despite EV getting pumped all the way back. Wow.
Rest in peace. I mean, that was a good try by them on
that
last
first
draw.
Yeah.
They shouldn't have been able to cap that TBH.
Yep, Demoman just gonna delay some capturing going on. Try to toss out that.
Yeah, he's just gonna be padding his stats.
Yeah, everyone's just gonna be having fun right now. 18 seconds left on the clock. Everyone getting that DM fights. Oof. I am genuinely surprised they actually capped that last point, bringing it to 3-2. Eevee's gonna get caught out, doesn't matter, 1 second left. GG's all around. Wow.
I mean... The soldiers were more ineffective in this mid. I mean, in these rounds. they're more ineffective in comparison to their product counterpart or their process gameplay. So I think they need to step up more if they want to win against the Prinnies next time. Mm-hmm. Yeah, but still very good play.
Yep, we got logs up on screen right now. The Prinny Pirates are going to take the map 3-2. Top damager is going to be LK, 284. Lil not too far behind at 257. Baxter at 254. Smiley 251. A lot of people in the 250 range. And then they're killed at 243. Top fragger is going to be Strelka with 28 kills. LK with 23. Those two scouts are pounding. 23, of course, tied together with Lil as well as Pandemic. Killer not too far behind at 22. What I really want to see are the stats on kills, and Smiley has killed the medic 5 times, Lo has killed the medic 4 times. Wow, okay.
Alright, Pandemic is asking- oh, never mind. Okay, so someone is asking me, someone, an anonymous player, is asking me if there's gonna be an interview.
No, not for, yeah, only placement matches.
Emphasis on anonymous.
Emphasis on anonymous, yeah. Yeah, so holy crap, good plays coming out from both teams. We had so many close matches. 3-2, 2-3, and then 3-2 again. Prinnies are going to be able to take both maps.
Fuck, I have for the race, like...
I mean, you could... This is the stats could see it's already painting a pretty accurate picture on why the red team lost. Mm-hmm. It's because in comparison to Eevee's stats, which is 9, and then Pokey's stats, which is 16, yeah, that's an enormous lead. So I believe they need to protect their medic more, or at least position him better so he doesn't fall for the insta-smiley blind bomb.
Yeah, the insta-smiley blind bomb. He just bombed so many times. Holy crap, it's just... damn.
Yeah, and his success rate was pretty good as well. Especially in that process and product game. Mm-hmm. He was on fire.
Oh yeah. Huge plays coming up from both teams. Wow. That is going to conclude it. Very close games. I'm very happy we got to cast this. 3-2, 2-3, 3-2 once again. Prinny's taking the product as well as the tiebreaker map. And the Koreans taking CP process. So that means the Koreans will be facing off against... Subnipuas in the following week in the lower bracket. Loser will get knocked out of AFC 13. Upper bracket, we will be seeing the Prinnies facing off against Seattle. So that is going to be a pretty interesting game. Yeah, holy crap. Good performance coming up from both teams.
Do you mind if I go for a shout out?
Yeah, sure, please. Let's move on to shout outs right now.
All right, shout out to the loser.
You got cut off, fam.
Oh, I'm sorry. Shout out to the losers that lost all of their Kachow points.
Hot damn.
That's what happens when you go for the top dog. You always vote for the underdog. 41%, boys.
41%. Yeah, shout out to all the people coming inside Twitch chat. Thank you all for hanging out. Really exciting games going on. I'm sure there are quite a number of you who are new to the Asia Fortress scene. Very happy that you guys actually managed to catch this game, because this was relatively close compared to all the other casts we had for the past season, where every time we've cast it, it's always been a 5-point difference. So this is a really good game, really exciting stuff, especially on product and even process. Holy crap, good games all around.
Yeah, that product last one was pretty good.
Oh, the product game was massive. Oof.
It was a tug of war, basically.
Oh yeah. And just that 3-round comeback from the Prinnies. Oof. Well played, well played. Congratulations to the Prinnies, of course. Shout out to you guys. Shout out to ESG, of course, for putting on a massive good show. Shout out to your two Sollies, Daylight, as well as Baxter for those bombs. Do you have any more shout outs you want to give before we close off?
Nah, that's all, dude.
That's all, just to the losers of the Kachas. Yeah, so thank you all for hanging out. Thank you, ifun, for hopping onto the panel.
All right, thanks for having me, friendo.
And that's going to be it for tonight. Thank you all, and see you guys potentially next week, I guess, for all the second week matches.
Is the stream dead? All right.